between Rebels Anarchy and Samsung Galaxy. I wonder if we're going to see Anarchy maybe change the name like before Anarchy. I mean, it was just Anarchy. Then it became Rebels Anarchy for some random reason.
I think they should just change it to Democracy Anarchy for the ultimate memeing.
Confusion effect.
Yeah, exactly.
Maybe just total anarchy. I like that. There's a Hecarim ban against Kuvei again. You know, Maokai, Hecarim, pretty much Kuvei's bread and butter these days. Does have a win on Ryze recently.
Yeah, Ixu's been playing more Ryze too, but he also has this weird top Gragas pick that he chooses from time to time. He's the only player in Korea who plays that champion, but it allows Anarchy to take a couple of junglers and try and deny that from the other team, and there's the Azir ban.
Yeah, so the first time in a long time, we're not going to see Crown play Azir. That's going to be interesting. And there's the Zed ban against Anarchy, keeping that away from Mickey, of course. But interesting, with the Azir already banned, that they would ban the Zed.
Well, there's still the possibility that Crown will play Victor here.
Oh, okay.
In that circumstance, you still maybe don't want to play against Mickey's Zed because he has been good on that champion. Anarchy will just go ahead and lock in the Alistar right off the bat. Grog is still available, but Eve has been preferring Echo, and of course his Nidalee is up too, so I think Anarchy believes that they will get Lyra's best champion in the second round of the draft.
Certainly could. There's a Gragas pickup. We'll see what they decide to go with. Maokai for Kuvei would be pretty par for the course there.
Right, and they're taking it away from Ixu too, because Ixu's main champions are also Hecarim and Maokai. So when you take the Maokai away, you deny that pick. It's going to force Ixu onto something kind of uncomfortable. Gragas taken by Eve, not a champion that we really associate with Eve, but certainly quite potent in the current meta. It basically fits into any composition, engage, disengage, has early game strength, has late game tankiness. He's pretty much the total package jungler right now.
Yeah, and they're going to go ahead and pick up Kog'Maw for their second choice. So Songin will be taking that, pretty standard stuff we've been seeing play a lot of those late game hyper carries.
Yeah, I don't know about taking the Kog'Maw this early because you might be setting yourself up to a lot of disruption and an all-in composition with Sivir. Sure, you'll do okay in the laning phase, but you're going to have to build a lot of peel from that point forward.
I feel like this is a spot where maybe that TF would work pretty well.
But I agree.
You can pick the bot lane right now.
Yeah, I agree. It could work well. They could be setting themselves up here for a quirky Ezreal composition. They already have good tools to deal with a Runeglaive Ezreal on the other team, should Anarchy select it, because it is available. I think the Nautilus is better here than the Janna. It's one more lockdown tool for the Ez.
Yeah, certainly a little bit stronger in terms of creating the picks and staying safe against that mid lane Ezreal that Mickey has been playing a few times lately.
So the question is, do they go for it?
Yeah.
In a situation where mid lane Ezreal would not be an ideal pick.
Yasuo is still available. We do have the knockup from Alistar, and Mickey has played a lot of it, but I don't know.
I don't think he's going to pick it blind when he doesn't know what his mid lane matchup is.
Pretty Ixu dangerous.
Ixu is going to be going the Fizz into Maokai, that very common counter pick that we see more and more of. So many pro players loving to take that Fizz into top and just 1v1 with a lot of jungle pressure to take out the Maokai early and start 4-1 splitting. And with the TF, there's going to be two people that could possibly come top to help out, feed Ixu's Fizz, so a nice composition for sure. But the problem is, there is virtually no peel for the Kog'Maw, like none. So Songyun, good luck and Godspeed, sir, this game, because there is nobody to help you.
He's going to have to hope that just TF decides to stick around and just gold card whoever comes close, but I don't know if he's going to get so lucky. Is Crown going to grab this Victor here?
Yeah, I think you just take the Victor. You get some explosive burst damage to take out the TF. You have a really good kiting composition if you're Samsung.
It's a solid team.
With a solid front line. So having Victor burst here is really, really nice.
Yeah, Anarchy is a pretty squishy team aside from Alistar Rek'Sai, so if that Victor can get a GBM-style flank off, you could pretty much wreck whoever's around.
Yeah, they have Anarchy's in a bit of an interesting situation where they are so squishy, except for the Alistar while he is ulting, that the Victor's burst damage is going to be, and it's AoE burst damage too. That's the difference. Of course, you do have the Runeglaive Ezreal, which provides some of those same factors, but it's nowhere near the same amount of AoE as a Chaos Storm.
Oh, yeah.
Plus a Death Ray, and then the consistent damage, too, from Victor's Qs when coupled with a Lich Bane.
Well,
so
if Anarchy groups up, Victor's just going to destroy them. That's like one combo from Victor would take off like 75% of the health of most of these champions.
Basically, Anarchy is hoping that they can super feed Ixu here and then get him in a good position where he can take over the game. But Rebels,
right.
Basically, Rebels is saying, if we don't win the laning phase very, very hard, we are going to lose this game. Because if you go into late game approximately equal in gold against this Samsung composition, they are just going to wreck you. That you have no safety. You have no way to prevent the Gragas and Maokai and Nautilus from getting on your carries.
Yeah.
And basically, Mickey's going to have to pull off some insane Twisted Fate moves to get onto Crown and Fury if they even want to start to turn that around. But that is, it's going to be really hard. So this is a huge snowball comp.
I'm surprised we didn't see something like Lucian for Sangin instead. But who knows? Going to game number one, Anarchy versus Samsung. Anarchy trying to avoid relegation. Let's see if they can. It's game time. And here we are once again. Welcome to Summoner's Rift, Rebels Anarchy versus Samsung Galaxy. And when I say avoid relegation for Anarchy, obviously even if they lose today, it doesn't guarantee any really bad news for them. But it's late enough in the season where you don't want to be put in that situation. We don't have a whole lot of weeks left here in the second round.
Yeah, we certainly don't. So Anarchy and Samsung just fanning out for the moment. No tricky invades coming in so far. Looks like we are going to have a lane swap into the top side, most likely from Samsung, which is to be expected. You don't want to end up in the 1v1 or the 2v2. The Kog'Maw will be poking you pretty severely before you hit level 6 if you're Corki, and then you definitely don't want to be 1v1 versus the Fizz if you can help it.
Oh, TF should really just keep his hat on, man. That is some pretty major hat hair that Twisted Fate is sporting there.
That's actually very awkward. It's like pasted to his head
and
like poofs out the back.
It's very mullet-esque.
Mullet.
You know, there's so many other sports skins. We need like a hockey Twisted Fate or something where he throws like pucks instead of cards. You're not supposed to ever touch the puck with your hand, though.
I don't think that even makes remote sense thematically.
I don't know.
Twisted Fate.
I got nothing.
How do you take Cajun Gambler and turn it into hockey player?
What about,
get out of here.
Well, what sport can we do for TF then? Darts?
Poker. See, it's already done. It was done for you.
Yeah, but like if you play, if you're poker pro, you just dress in normal clothes, though.
No, I'm just saying it's already been done. I mean, there is no other sport that will fit Twisted Fate.
I don't know. Maybe like Magic the Gathering TF or something.
For that beautiful crossover.
There you go. And instead of gold card, he has like a foil card. Something. Yep. He's like, he says things like, can I trade you for your ball lightning? That's a card that I used to use a lot.
I remember that.
Yeah.
I think I have a German version of that card.
Really?
Yeah.
What's ball lightning in German?
I have no idea. Blitz something. That's what I got.
All right.
I don't know what ball is.
I don't know either. Twitter, help us. Somebody out there knows. Twitter speaks every language. Mickey pushing Crown under the turret pretty fast here. But not a lot of early ganking threats for this TF in mid lane, so he can do that. Wraith getting a little bit annoying as Snowflower puts on the ward, but we do have the support helping the top lane up in top. Seems like a good place to go if you want to help the top lane, I suppose.
Probably want to be there, but the lane swap is going through for Samsung, so they will be quite happy about this situation. And this is also going to delay probably Mickey's first use of his ultimate. Not sure he's really going to have too many good targets, because by the time he hits 6, it's likely that Sangyun will still have not got back.
Hello.
Yeah, Wraith can be aggressive right now, Ixu.
Yeah.
Not with much there in terms of ability to trade. But basically, once the TF hits 6, it's just not going to be much to gank. There's not going to be sufficient damage for Sangyun and him to take out a Maokai in the bottom side. And here comes Eve.
Yeah, they're going to try to make a play here on the Mickey, but already running into the river. Takes a big poke from the Death Ray, but really won't lose a lot with that lane already pushed up.
Death Ray is really a misnomer. It rarely actually can kill anybody.
That's true. Whoa, oh, Fury wow. Nearly killed right there. Snowflower almost dead as well.
Yeah, Fury not choosing to use his heal or his flash, so putting it right to the brink. Snowflower did use his exhaust in whatever happened in that trade in the top lane.
I guess so.
But Wraith back up now. Rek'Sai there. Lane gank might be coming in for Eve.
This could be really dangerous for Fury if Lyra decides to go
summoner
through try
heal.
Here.
He still has summoner heal. He's okay.
Yeah, I guess he does have both summoners. He's going to go ahead and try to recall right now. Looks like he will with that lane pushed up. And so no more danger for Fury. You're right, though, for Victor. It's not so much of a death ray. It's more of like a pain ray. Because it does hurt. It's not a tickle ray, that's for sure.
Depends on how fed you are. It definitely can be a tickle ray.
Yeah. It's like a extreme discomfort ray. But that's just too long, you know? Too long of a name. Whoa, that was nearly a death ray.
Well, it's only a death ray, and if it actually, takes most of the life away from... It doesn't count if it's a finisher, you know?
It's true. Well, I mean,
It has to do the vast majority of the damage. Oh. Just call it Chaos Ray, and then call it Death Storm instead.
Well, I mean, if you intend to cause death with the ray, even if you don't, it's still technically a death ray, I suppose. Because the intent is there, just not the results.
So if I throw my pen at you with the intent to cause death, I can call it a death pen right now?
Yeah, sure. I mean, theoretically, yeah, you totally
all
can.
Right. So it's all about intent with you. No, not about reality at all. Noah, you exist...
In terms of naming.
You exist on a plane where intention and emotion is everything. Actual physical objects.
Yeah, man. I've taken that Myers-Briggs test.
Actual physical objects are meaningless.
It's not the result. It's the intent sometimes in terms of naming, right?
No. That doesn't. And no,
the thing
it's
is,
not.
in your assumptions, you're thinking that this makes it a good name. But no, you can have a really badly named something.
So you're just a bad name advocate, I see.
No, I'm just saying you can name things badly. Within reality, you have that choice.
Okay.
We're getting really close to me going off on modern art again. Better stop now.
Dang, I want to hear that, actually.
We would literally talk about nothing else
I would
the next
agree with you
5
on
hours.
Words, so.
Yeah. Oh, boy. Well, Lyra coming in for a lane gank here in top lane, but I don't know really if there's going to be a lot of opportunity for this. He just wants to push it up, I suppose. All right. Well, there you have it. Nice lane pushing, Lyra. Well, actually, no. It just goes right back to mid. Didn't really work out.
Not as exciting as we had hoped.
No.
So early back, actually, Sungyoon did go back and get the parts of a fade throughout all that. Nobody really trying to make a move. Both top laners getting adequate farm for the time being. And we're just kind of waiting on Mickey to do something here because that's going to be the key to everything that's happening so far.
Yeah, he's got that level 6, and you know we've talked time and time again about how important those first couple TF ultimates are. You really need to make a play with those, otherwise TF just becomes a bit on the useless side.
And it's hard to make a play in a lane swap with that ultimate. He does have the level 2 shoes. He also has Ignite this game, which is something we didn't talk about. That is a bit odd. One would think that he would have gone for Ghost if he felt comfortable in a given situation. Do they really need two Ignites if Ixu's going to be putting down his?
Well, it certainly is aggressive, and like you said, they need to make a lot of plays in the early game here if they want to start that snowball.
But the thing about Ghost with TF is that it guarantees that you're going to land another card when you try and make a gank, especially if you're going to be going for some boots too. You're going to be very, very sticky on your target. And if you get the Ignite, sometimes that's not as effective as just having another gold card or a red card or two while you're in the pursuit of your gank.
Well, Samsung is playing against this really well as well. They see Snowflower coming down towards bot lane. I mean, they have a ward to watch Mickey when he lives lane as well, so there's just not going to be any opportunities to gank this Maokai down in bot.
Well, and are there going to be opportunities to gank for this Fizz? Yes, they have burst, but they have very little crowd control for the initiation. Fizz not going to be offering much in that department, so they're kind of reliant on where Snowflower goes with this Alistar on the map.
I feel like they need Samsung to make a mistake. Like, they need Samsung to go for, like a early foolish dragon or something like that and then just fight it out, but I don't know. This is... looking a bit less than inspiring here for
I am really not a fan of this composition. I don't like compositions that require extreme snowballing to actually win a game. If you have to win lane super hard to win a game, then you probably have drafted incorrectly.
Yeah, it's rolling the dice pretty hard for sure. They're going to come in onto this blue buff, so trying to keep this away from Mickey, which is kind of nice for Samsung. And looks like they will be able to do just that. Oh, close for Lyra. Did he actually get that?
Yes, he did.
I think he did. Wow.
Crown actually messed up the transfer, left it with about 25 HP. So Lyra able to get the smite.
Crown still has his own blue buff for a little while anyway.
Yeah, he didn't get the refresh, which is what he was looking for. But denying it from Mickey is really more important thing, although it doesn't actually hurt TF that badly. Of course, he does have blue cards for sustain if he needs them, and he already has a good CDR with the boots.
Mickey's owned up by that gravity shield. Chaos Storm comes down, but Wraith way behind. No play made by Nautilus. Crown may have gone in a little bit early on that one. Well, you can have pizza. It's okay, man. Don't be embarrassed. The whole crowd had pizza the other day.
Yeah, that was quite nice.
Even we got pizza.
We did get pizza.
Yeah.
It was mediocre.
It was solidly mediocre, but at least it didn't have corn in it. That was nice. Whoa! Meanwhile, TF ultimate activated. Wraith comes in. Flash. Snowflower avoids that explosive cask, so he gets out with only that summoner used. Mickey, though, burns that out with no results, though. And now it's going to be a dragon for Samsung. Uh-oh. Things are not going well for Anarchy.
Well, that's a big use of that ult in the mid lane. They just couldn't do anything with that. They couldn't even take control in order to get an objective like this dragon. So that's going to be pretty easily taken here by Samsung. And they are starting to kind of ramp up right now. Kuve moving into the top side. We'll see what happens when he gets into a lane with the Fizz. He has a couple Doran's Ring. He has the sustain from the Catalyst, so he's in pretty good position. But Iksu going for some physical damage. Kuve is a couple items away from actually being able to seriously deal with the Fizz if there are ganks coming in.
Well, this might be the opportunity that Anarchy is looking for then, if they can get things in position when that TF ult comes up again. Maybe, just maybe, they can make something happen, but it's already getting a little bit late for snowballing the early game anyway.
Yeah, I mean, they still have some time here to work with for sure, and you can tell right now Sanghyun doing a very good job just harassing this Corki. These shorter range AD carries have trouble with the Kog'Maw in the laning phase unless you have a chance to gank him or go all in, and you really don't want that to be turned around on you by a Twisted Fate at the moment. So it's pretty much just up to Samsung to play next to their towers, wait until they can get group and then fight on some objectives, and make that TF very useless, because TF is only going to be useful in the team fights once he gets Azonia's Hourglass, because if he goes back into the back line without one of those, Victor will just instantly 100-0 him.
Yeah. Well, here we have our duo lane yet again.
Now, Anarchy does have a chance to 1-3-1 split push this game. They can definitely go for that kind of strategy here with the Fizz and the TF and then hold the Kog'Maw in the mid lane.
Do you feel like it'd be fairly easy for Samsung to just all in on the three-man part of that, though, since there just isn't much peel for Sanghyun?
Yeah, there isn't, and that's
a
big problem.
There we go. Flash Body Slam, gold card right there, though. Knock up, and Eve's in a lot of trouble. First blood goes to Mickey. Lyra getting very, very low. Crown on the run. There's another gold card. May have overextended there. Mickey, though, fairly low health. Can't quite kill off Crown. He's going to teleport in. Tries to make play. Snowflower comes in with that headbutt pulverized. Mickey gets the double this fight. Unofficial double, but Wraith manages to get a bit of revenge. Now going after Snowflower, but shouldn't be able to take him out. There we go.
Yeah.
So a couple kills.
Bit of a mistake there from Eve going under the turret and just being stopped dead in his tracks after his flash with that gold card. So he wasn't capable of really making that dive. They didn't have enough information about Lyra, who just showed up instantly to turn it around. Fortunately for Crown, Wraith was there in the mid lane. But as much as that hurts and as much as trading that 2-for-1 isn't good for Samsung, they got another TF ult, and it's not snowballing Iksu, which is really quite good for them because Kuve is still doing okay in this lane.
Yeah. Yeah, I think it seems like Iksu needs to make some sort of play by himself at this point, which is a lot to ask when the lane's been going pretty much even after that swap.
Yeah, and what all that Samsung has to do is ride out this power spike. Anarchy has three genes right now. Just hold your towers. Don't let them get the auto attacks on the turret with the Sheen. Don't let them snowball the game off of turret global gold, and you're going to be fine.
Hmm. Three Sheens is still nothing compared to the amount that Hollywood has.
Those are a lot of Sheens. Too many Sheens, really. Could drop a few of those.
That's true. Could upgrade those into something else, perhaps. Well, it's a battle of wards now. That's all I've got to say about that.
No follow-up?
Nope.
No epic commentary?
I was counting on you to be like, yes, and here's intricate, detailed analysis of why.
Just a warden,
nope.
Dude.
Just a ward.
Wards. Just some wardens.
Just some wards.
That's it. Nothing more to it right now.
What ward skin do you use?
Standard.
Really? You don't skin your wards?
I haven't played League of Legends in 5 months, so.
Ah. I played some last night.
How was it?
Well, ranked was down, so I had to play normals. And I duoed with Barry. We did a bot lane where I played Tahm Kench, and I kept stealing kills from him. I don't know if he's going to want to play with me for a while. And then we lost the game. It was not good for Barry. I had fun, but...
Did you eat Barry?
I did, a couple times. That's right. It was more just like eating the people he was about to kill so I could get it.
Well done, sir. Well done indeed.
Oh, yeah.
Waddling away.
My hunger cannot be sated.
But that's the problem, is that he doesn't ever actually eat anything.
He just spits it out and then it dies.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Well, no wonder it can't be sated. You're not digesting it, Tahm Kench.
Yep. Speaks the truth. We already talked about this. Tahm Kench.
Not so smart.
No. Riot almost promoting eating disorders there. I'm a little bit worried about the intent of this champion. They're just promoting just licking things. That's right. Don't eat it. Just lick it.
Lick it good.
That was on the list of rejected mottos for Nike. They're like, just lick it, just slap it, just twist it. No, just do it. That's perfect. We're going to use that. All those other ones, no.
I wish they had gone with something else.
That's right. Oh, Mickey. Getting a little bit aggressive with Crown here, but with no Ignite on Crown, he really can't push this too quickly, can he?
Nope, just want to be there holding it. They're getting some damage down onto the tower. Fury right now, going for those auto attacks, and we do see Eve there just to zone the Kog'Maw off, so they're able to start to reverse the pressure on this wave right before the dragon starts. Anarchy trying to stack up right here.
TF ultimate is up.
Yeah, TF's ultimate is up, but Kube's back in base right now, so buying that Righteous Glory. They just want to prevent the dragon from going down. Again, it's all about Samsung's ability to hold right now.
This isn't a bad timing for Anarchy to try to contest this dragon, though. They just finished both their Trinity forces. Mickey's got his Lich Bane as well. I wonder if they could fight this.
Oh, they definitely like they could. Can. They definitely can if they could push up far enough to make it worth it. But there is good wave clear on Victor and on this Corki at the moment. And we see Eve just hanging around at the bottom side of the map. So there's a choice to be made. And Anarchy, basically by Eve staying bottom side, this is very smart. Because if Anarchy commits to top side, well then, okay, fine. Samsung gets the dragon.
Yeah.
And if they commit to bottom side, well, Kuve's going to be safe enough in this matchup. Sure, he's falling behind by a few CS, but that's to be expected if he doesn't want to get all in and killed right now before he has any MR or armor to deal with this Fizz.
Yeah. You'd prefer to be not dead.
I often prefer to be not dead, Doa.
It's my favorite state of being. Well, Mickey just going to recall. Picks up a Blasting Wand, a little bit more damage for him. And Samsung knows that this dragon is a little bit difficult to take right now, a little bit unsafe, so they're just going to go ahead and leave it for the moment.
Yeah, they're trying to recall right now before the TF can get back into lane and before the setup could happen on the dragon, but both dual lanes actually recalling simultaneously.
Yeah, but Fury cancels his, as does Songyun. This is kind of letting Ixu get even farther ahead in CS. Oh, Mickey, found by Eve. He has a gold card loaded up, but he flashes over the wall. A little bit of damage. Lyra comes down as well. Even a little bit of trouble, has to use his flash. Ixu fish right on Eve. Oh, he missed it! Didn't hit him, so it looks like Gragas gets out. Teleport coming down from Kuve as well.
Well, really surprising that Kuvay actually didn't cancel that TP. Maybe a little bit worried about what could happen to his team if the TF came in with the ultimate.
But I think they're just going to take the dragon now.
Well,
I
they can try for sure. But the problem is they, I mean, we have a Void Rush that's still available.
I suppose with the health so low on Eve, it's just a little bit dangerous, a little bit too dangerous. But Ixu does go back up to top lane, so it looks like if anything else, they'll try to trade this top lane turret for the dragon, depending on how Anarchy can do, because Ixu's not going to be there if there's a fight.
Yeah, Maokai here right now in the mid lane, just holding the minion wave while they wait for Eve to approach. Mickey feints going up into top. Instead decides to get back into mid, and now Maokai just has every opportunity to go back up top for free.
Yep.
That was not very well played by Anarchy.
And just going to give Samsung that second dragon, and will they even get that top lane turret? It had a lot of health, but it looks like Ixude has just enough to take that down.
Yeah, and that's nice at least. You want that immediate gold if you're Anarchy. It is about the split push right now for you. So it's definitely a trade that you're going to be willing to make because you just need the items now.
Yeah.
To make that impact and to create a big enough gold gap. And they're starting to move in that direction. They have a healthy lead at the moment. And Mickey has that. I mean, they've got two Trinity Forces and a Lich Bane. Their burst damage is pretty crazy.
Yeah, so do you think they could put some pretty decent pressure on some of these turrets right now, despite the wave clear from Samsung?
It depends on if they can get Mickey out of the mid lane or not. Again, you really are going to 1-3-1 this once the TF ult comes back up, which isn't too long now because he has so much CDR already.
True. And Songyun's been able to farm pretty well this game as well. A little bit of wards in the river there. And it looks like they will just push up this mid lane for now.
Yeah, but there's so much wave clear that is that actually going to do
anything? Oh, teleport coming in.
Nice job. Just Val could flash out.
Yep.
And there's no follow-up. They can't take that dragon anymore. Already gone. Taken by Samsung. So instead, what they're giving up is just a Maokai freezing in the top side. They can't actually stop Kuvay from doing this unless they go all in.
Small consolation that Fury's flash is going to be down longer than Mickey's Gate of Destiny, I suppose, but
it's really not that big of a deal.
Yeah. I mean, Samsung can just sit back and play relatively safe.
Yeah, there's the Wolf Spirit. So Anarchy, knowing that they can't do anything about this freeze right now, instead is just going to commit to the tower.
This is getting to be a pretty serious gold lead, actually, for Anarchy. They're going to be about 5K ahead after this.
Yes, they are, but again, their 5v5 is not going to be strong in the late game, so they have to have this kind of 4K. They need more than this, actually. They need to keep rolling with these outer turrets.
Yeah.
Now, we can question Kuvay's kind of delayed push on Maokai. Of course, he is trying to concentrate that farm, catch up personally, but when he's doing that, there is no other place for Ixu to be, and that means that he is able to threaten a dive on the bottom side to take another tier one.
Yeah, it just doesn't seem like Anarchy's ever going to find the time to get the kills on their carries that they need, specifically on Ixu and Mickey.
Yep.
I guess if they stay even, can they still split push enough, you know?
Yeah, and they have an advantage where the Aegis is very effective. I mean, Aegis is very effective for both teams in this particular circumstance because Kog'Maw does so much magic damage too.
True.
But yeah, they may be able to out team fight if they can continue this lead. That's going to be it. They're really teetering on the brink right now of what they're going to be able to do in this game. And you can see the Luden's Echo finished fast for Crown. He just wants more wave clear right now.
Right. Makes sense. And Samsung coming in. They may be able to find a pick on the Slowflower here. Exhaust used on the Crown. Oh, nice dredge line. Max range for Wraith. He pops the ult onto Songyun as well. That's going to be a lot of damage coming in from Crown with that Chaos Storm. Looks like Songyun's going to get out, but a kill for Samsung. Fury picks one up. Mickey, though, starting that split push.
And they want to do this. They're committing to it. No one is there to stop him. Mickey has to leave. He doesn't have the wards at the moment. And there is Corki coming. He's just going to just try and ult right onto Corki. Not going to work. Now has to go back again.
Yeah, just running away. Oh,
without that ghost, he can't actually complete a play like that.
It's interesting to note. I mean, this is one of the first Ignite Twisted Fates we've seen in a while, and it definitely kind of showcases, I think, the usefulness of Ghost specifically.
Well, at the very least, even though he didn't have the Ghost, he did stop the push in the mid lane through the pressure onto the tier two. So yeah, he is able to make sure that Samsung doesn't get anything at all off of the kill that they picked up in mid onto Alistar.
All in onto Kuve. Ixu trying to get the kill there, doing a lot of damage, but Kuve able to hit him with the Arcane Smash. So Ixu not getting that 1v1. Split push continuing, though.
Well, this is how it's going to be for a while. Anarchy is the one dictating the pace of this game, and it's just up to Samsung to see if they don't lose any more turrets and they can maybe contest this next dragon.
They really
have an opportunity.
They really can't let the pressure off for a second, can they, too?
Nope. No, they cannot. Well, both top laners have TP. Ixu running a little bit low on mana, but he's still feeling pretty comfortable with what's going on in top.
Yeah, dragging up in about a minute, too. So that may be Anarchy's big opportunity to blow this game wide open if they can force a good fight there, or at least take one for themselves.
Yeah, but taking one for themselves isn't enough. We already see Samsung. It would be great if they had gotten the first two dragons with their skirmishers, but they just weren't able to pick it up.
So you think Samsung's just going to let him have it?
Definitely a viable choice for Samsung. If you're Samsung, sometimes it'd be better to go ahead and try and climb back into the game in terms of gold and just frankly push out the side waves to delay this game even further for Anarchy that's relying on side wave pressure to win.
That makes sense.
Anarchy also didn't deny the blue buff to Crown. They just don't have good deep wards, especially in the bottom side. You can see right now there are two pinks, in the bottom four Samsung just to prevent any kind of vision going down for Anarchy. They want to black that out so that TF isn't too comfortable pushing very far forward down the lane.
Right.
Dragons up.
Yep, Samsung going for it. Anarchy needs to stop this from happening. If they let Samsung get three dragons without the kills, and they're going to try. Dragon at about half health right now. Teleport coming in from Anarchy. Here it is. Nice headbutt. Pulverize doesn't slow them up enough, though. Snowflower in a little bit of trouble. Eve on the run already. Lyra in the middle of everything. And Songyun zoning on the top of the fight right now. Lyra and Snowflower have to make a run for it. Where is Mickey in all of this? Couldn't find a place to teleport in, and Samsung doesn't want to give up this dragon. They're coming back in again. There's a teleport coming in for Mickey. Now there's a kill for Ixu as well. Kills coming in for Anarchy, but now Samsung may be turning it around. Doesn't look like they can do it quite enough, though. Such an even fight. Dragon taken by Anarchy. That is big, and Anarchy able to go 1-for-4 and the dragon.
Well, Lyra actually is going to make it out right there. Well, that was, fighting right there for Samsung, it looked really good at first, which is why they pulled back, but they couldn't get enough burst down onto anybody to actually take out Anarchy, so they found themselves in a bit of a rough situation. Now they're going to lose two towers as a result of that fight, but the big part was that Kuve got pulled over the back of the Dragon Wall by Songyun, and they really needed him to provide lockdown for Corki as they cleaned that up.
Lyra's right there to try to save his jungler. Fury flashes ahead for it. Oh, man, this is crazy. Oh, Lyra could be in a lot of trouble. Raptor's helping Fury get another one. He's got three kills so far this game already. Not too bad. It's an aggressive Corki right there.
Well, at least he got somewhat of a turnaround, even if that Rek'Sai is not going to be out off the map for too terribly long. Well, this is the kind of lead that Anarchy can really start to work with now. This is where their split push becomes very, very difficult to deal with. Ixu has that Blade of the Ruined King. Kuve still struggling to get enough resists.
For the meantime, though, they need to try to stop this mid lane turret from going down. It doesn't look like they'll be able to. Ixu and Snowflower coming up. Ixu does have his ult back. And wow, that turret has 5 health. They can just breathe on it lightly for now. Although Crown can't do that because he's wearing a mask. He'd have to like take it off and then breathe on it.
I'm sure he could manage that somehow.
It's true. He can just like wave his hand in the small
the third hand
waft of air. The third hand even. Yeah, it's true. He can just poke it with his third hand. Well, Anarchy, like you mentioned, jumping out to about a 7K gold lead right now. Getting some of the kills they need. And getting some kills and assists onto Ixu, too, helps out quite a bit.
Yeah, it does. It's all coming in for him. So, and the with the Zonya's Hourglass complete now for Mickey, they have another way to engage. And if he can lock down the Victor and prevent the burst, that could be pretty nice for Mickey in that back line and could give Fizz and him enough time because they have the item advantage now and they have this huge amount of burst as a result. While Samsung still struggling to catch up as Kuvei definitely not as tanky as he would like to be. Crown still a little bit low on damage.
Samsung, though, seemingly just kind of walk around the map to bully their way through some turrets, so. Ooh. Crown, okay, ultimate used. TF's gonna try to come in, gonna find Kuvei. Kuvei in a little bit of trouble with the damage from Songyun as well. This is bad news for the top laner. That's another kill for Mickey. Meanwhile, Snowflower gets all in by Crown, trying to get away, but he's right under that Chaos Storm. Looks like he'll be able to make it out with that tankiness from his ultimate. Alistar is pretty hard to bring down sometimes.
Well, Kuvei just has no MR yet. He's trying to build into this Frozen Heart, but he just has the Ninja Tabby and the components for the Frozen Heart. So there's really nothing that he can do to stop Mickey's damage that's coming in, nor the percent HP damage from Kog'Maw's Bio-Arcane Barrage. So he's going to be very vulnerable to a split push from the Twisted Fate or any pick attempt. That's why the kill was so easy, even onto a Maokai.
Yeah, that split push starting to really do work now, too, for Anarchy. Pressuring the top and the mid, or the top and the bottom, and the mid, really. All three. Mickey taking the blue buff. And Samsung is really getting to the point where they either need to win a massive fight right now, or they're going to just continuously be pushed back for the rest of the game.
Yep. And Anarchy, to their credit, is doing a good job of keeping them split up. They broke the last fight around the dragon into a series of small skirmishes, which does favor them, especially when they have that large gold lead. So, and they've played out the laning phase with Mickey in bottom and Iksu in his lane assignment at top, just kind of going for it, while they have advanced their ward line deep into the enemy jungle. Look how many deep wards on both sides are there for Anarchy right now. Warding has definitely been a strength of theirs this entire season. They've had the information, just not the play to back it up or the decision-making to play around that vision. However, this time, it's all going quite well.
Well, it's funny to see how they've been able to make this Kog'Maw work, too, because it's not really peel in the traditional sense. It's kind of peel by fragmentation, right? You just split up the other team so much that there's no way to really go in, and then this Kog'Maw can just pick somebody out on the outside and 1v1 them.
Well, yeah, especially if he has his flash up. That probably is the bigger factor here. Is if he doesn't have his flash, I'm not sure he's going to be doing so well, because especially in that last dragon fight, if he had not flashed over the back of the dragon pit, we're going to see him just TP right here for a ward. Not going to commit to a 1v1, just using the Destiny for a little bit of vision.
Yep, well, with dragon coming up in 30, they certainly want all the vision they can get on the map right now, and they pretty much have all of it.
Yep, and now they can start thinking about this Baron. Baron is dangerous, though, because they're not very tanky.
Yeah, they started it, though.
And they're going to be going for it. Somebody needs to start getting vision here from Samsung. There we go.
This is the opportunity that Samsung has been looking for. Wraith immediately flashing in to just start to upset the Anarchy team. Eve gets knocked up as well. Kuvei getting in the back lines, not even needing to teleport. Iksu picks up a kill here. Anarchy turning onto everybody. Samsung coming in very fragmented. That's a double kill for Iksu now. Baron doing a lot of work as well. There goes Rek'Sai finally. Double kill for Crown coming into all of this. Meanwhile, Fury on the run. They're going to chase him into their own jungle. Songyun can chase him down just fine, it looks like. There's a kill. Meanwhile, Crown picks up another one onto Snowflower. A massive team fight. Iksu, though, finishes the ace for Team Anarchy. Three kills for him in that fight. And Anarchy, really, again, it looked a little bit dangerous, but now you can see they're pretty happy about that. They're getting the skirmishes, and that's working.
And they can take it to the dragon next. So let's take a look at that fight again. Wraith comes in, has to commit. He wants to stop the DPS, so he goes on to Songyun. Somehow, though, Eve actually picks up the Baron aggro. It takes a bunch of damage from the Baron. Fury already low, but he and Crown are able to burst out Mickey nearly immediately. And there's a Death Ray to take yet another one. But it's a 2v3 moving forward from this point. And Snowflower is going to die as Songyun pursues. Little bit of a messy fight from Anarchy. Songyun and Iksu both going over to the flank.
Well, it was messy, but that's exactly what they wanted. I mean, they ended up coming out really well in that team fight. They're 10k gold ahead now. I mean, Fizz and TF both have 4 kills. It's looking really, really good for Anarchy right now.
Yeah, and this kind of composition, it can work if you get enough of an advantage in the laning phase. Like I said, I just don't like betting on that. Mm-hmm. Because it's an unnecessary risk, but here we go again.
Anarchy living up to the name here. This is what they want to cause. Snowflower coming in with that Righteous Glory. And where's the rest of the engage here? He's going to teleport just to the bot lane and try to push that up, I suppose.
One thing we have seen from Anarchy, though, is when Mickey can split push, he typically makes pretty good decisions. We've seen how he does on Zed. That has come up big in some of the Anarchy's wins, that when he gets fed and when he's allowed to split push, he knows how to and when to apply pressure.
Well, the 5 hit point turret finally goes down. That survived for like a good 5 minutes at least. Wow. Samsung invading the enemy jungle as well to try to claim this blue buff. And it looks like they're going to go ahead and give that up. Nobody's been able to get the Baron quite yet. Mickey moving into the mid lane. Looks like they're going to maybe make a play for the tier 2 there. It's been an exciting game.
Certainly has been. Plenty of kills.
I like it. It's been messy. It's been a brawl. This is my kind of game.
It definitely has been both of those things, Doug.
I've had a soft spot in my heart all season long for Anarchy, and it's games like this that are the reason. It's not the most strategic game. It's not the cleanest game, but it's really fun.
I mean, I think that Anarchy is showing quite a good use of split push here at 1-3-1, which we don't actually get to see too many times in the current meta.
Yeah.
And the reason is because it's very hard to close with it. As we're seeing right now, Anarchy has a 10K gold lead, but it's not safe for them to take Baron because they're still quite squishy. And if they all get caught in there, it could just be ace and game over. Now, if they can get the Baron and resume the split pushing, it'll be quite easy to finish. But you can't. It's so difficult just to split push the actual inhibitors without the Baron buff itself.
Yeah, it seems like Anarchy's going to need to get sneaky, or they're going to need to win a pretty one-sided team fight near Baron.
Yeah, you can see they're really reluctant to start it.
Yep.
And it's like it's going to be started for them, actually.
Oh, are they? Okay, they're going to go in. Fury knows this is happening, helping out a little bit. He's like, hey, I'll help damage that Baron for you. Anarchy gets it down to about half health. Samsung throws on the ward. They know what's up. They're going to go in. Here comes the teleport. They come in. Baron still goes to Anarchy, but they immediately lose Lyra. They're going to lose more than that as Snowflower gets in trouble. Alt onto Mickey. He's in big trouble. Meanwhile, a kill for Iksu. Anarchy trying to turn the round. Zonya's not going to help Mickey out too much. And Samsung, they don't prevent the Baron, but they do get 2 kills on the way out. One of the split pushers not going to have the Baron. Was it enough for Samsung, though?
I mean, you're still coming down in the gold lead. Right now, Samsung just has to hope that they're going to a 6-item late game, that they're going to get another 10 minutes or so to deal with this. Because if they can get another 10 minutes, they're still going to be in fine position. It's not like Anarchy is rapidly approaching 5 dragons or anything of the sort.
So these like next few minutes are crucial for Anarchy, because they either need to make the Barons that they have really work. Oh, there's the engage right onto Songyun. Songyun trying to get away with that cleanse, but Eve is all over him anyway. Snowflower has to flash away. Here comes Lear with a huge 3-man knockup. Oh boy, Anarchy turning this one around in a hurry as Iksu comes down with the teleport. He's all over Fury right now as well, and Songyun just poking from the back lines. Double kill for Songyun, and Iksu wants to get one as well onto Fury. He will. Iksu's had a huge game on this Fizz, and he's not done yet. Ult onto Wraith. He hadn't even used it yet. Wow. Over the wall, and that's another one. The ace for Anarchy. Well, talk about making the next few minutes work. Break out your cameras, because this is a Kodak moment for Team Anarchy.
Well, yeah, they should just be able to push to victory right here. At least they're going to get one Nexus turret. That's the bare minimum.
I think this is going to be it.
Songyun actually coming up big in some of these fights. Still hasn't died yet this game.
Yeah, Crown and Eve coming up in less than 10 seconds.
So
but in less
many
than 10
Sheens.
Seconds, this game's going to be over. Too many Sheens. Too many Sheens for Samsung to handle, and this game is over. Anarchy takes a pretty bloodthirsty game one. I like it.
Yeah, well, they played out that comp nicely.
Yes.
They understood the risk with it, but they got ahead enough due to the tower kills and the picks they were able to set up, and especially Samsung not just kind of playing too aggressively in multiple situations in that game. Don't have to go for every dragon. You could have let that one go right when you didn't have necessarily the items to go ahead and finish that one off. Samsung remembering right now, they lost to Anarchy 2-0 earlier in this season. Are they going to repeat that same fate?
You know, if I thought this match was going to be a 2-0, I thought it was going to be for Samsung, if anybody. I think we're going to go to three games still, but between Samsung Galaxy and Rebels Anarchy, no roster swaps with either team. And with the way Iksu played, I don't think Anarchy's going to be doing that anytime soon.
So Ezreal is going to be the first band, followed by the Rise. And so is this going to go into the banning of Mickey, as we frequently see on the blue side? No. Kragas.
Yeah. And the Azir ban, once again, for Anarchy. So really wanting Crown to just play something other than that champion who's played so much lately, although he did just fine on the Victor last game for the most part. But as a team, they just kept falling back.
So will it be the Kalista banned last? Here.
If you give Fury Kalista, I was going to say, that is a dangerous prospect.
I agree with you. We haven't even seen a Kalista game in what seems like forever.
Yeah, she's just been banned pretty much nonstop.
Permanently, definitely for the last few weeks. So, Alistar, the first pick here. Lyra hovering over that Nidalee. Probably much more likely to take the Rek'Sai, though. Will we get to see some of Eve's Nidalee in this next game?
I really think he should take the Rek'Sai.
Yeah, I think he will too. He's not going to bother to deny the Nidalee. It's either ban it or leave it up and just take a different jungler. I think that's the philosophy you have to go around with these jungle Nidalee players.
Now, could you just grab the Hecarim right now to keep that away from Kuvei?
I mean, you could. They banned it last time. They're obviously concerned about that, which makes sense considering they were picking the Kog'Maw, but an early Kog pickup here, they are supremely confident in Sangyun, it would appear.
Yeah, well, he had a pretty great game in game number one. But they're going to go with the Shen. Huh.
Shen and Rek'Sai. So,
if they end up taking the TF again, this is like the ultimate global pick comp.
get Zhonya's first TF ports in.
If only they had Tahm Kench, they could add on to this.
There's instantly a Shen in your back line alongside a TF.
That's right. Well, how many people... Sangyun could be ulted by Shen, and then Sangyun would jump into Tahm Kench with Snowflower, who would go to the same place that TF and Rek'Sai are going to, so all five members of the team could just appear somewhere.
It's better with Kalista because you can use your Fates Call and then go into Tahm Kench.
That's true.
And then the Shen ults the Tahm Kench.
So everybody comes out of Tahm Kench, basically. Tahm Kench eats the world, and Nidalee going to be picked up for Eve, and that's going to be a Kog'Maw for Fury as well. Huh. I think we just need to find out if we can fit all five members of the team into Tahm Kench at once.
I'm sure there's a way to do it.
Probably.
So, Yasuo will be locked in blind.
Wow.
Now
that is odd.
That is very odd. I suppose technically it may still be going in the... I don't even know. It could still go in the top lane. We could still see Shen support. We have never seen Shen support in Korea, but that doesn't mean it's not necessarily a flex pick here for Anarchy.
St. Vicious would certainly be happy if we saw that Shen support.
Well, I would be sad, but that's a different story.
All right. You know, if this is Korea, so we could see Yasuo support just like we see on the solo queue ladder every day.
Now, Crown, if he locks in this Fizz, he is a good Fizz player. Remember that one of SK Telecom's losses actually came to Crown when he played against EasyHoon and killed EasyHoon's Cassiopeia three times in lane with Fizz.
Hmm.
So definitely a possibility here that we could see.
And it may be that support Shen after all if this Rumble gets locked in.
Of course, Anarchy, you would be the ones doing this.
Yeah. Why not? Hey, I mean, support Shen. More pick opportunity, you know? Mind that with the equalizer, but not a lot of knockups on the Anarchy side.
They have Rek'Sai, that's about it so far.
That is exactly it so far.
That is, and when they're not able to pick Maokai right here, they're going to just take the Annie instead, so no support Shen.
You know, part of the criticism for Yasuo lately is that he's just so squishy these days. And so if Yasuo goes in with a Shen ulting on him, that does kind of solve a lot of that. So I like the synergy.
Yeah, I agree with you. That's a very good point. that does carry some synergy right there to help Mickey keep going. The last time Mickey did play Yasuo, he played it quite well, actually.
He's been playing it a lot this season.
He won a game against Najin with it, and he looked really good in the skirmishing and the team fights. He wasn't playing the same kind of one-shot style. He found clever ways to skirt the edges, get some damage down before actually triggering that last breath and going all in. But if you just look at the possible wombo combo here from Anarchy, Annie stun, if it catches three people and Lyra flash on Burrows under them, holy cow, that is going to be a lot of damage with a few rockets thrown in there too.
So you are all dead. And then Shen taunts all three of you when you land, just in case, you know?
Yeah, this is actually a pretty fun combo composition from Rebels Anarchy. Meanwhile, Samsung, they've got some skirmishing power, but it's mostly just going to be a little bit of poke from Nidalee and the Kog'Maw, and then a finisher once they can actually go in with the Maokai to get some executes for the Fizz. So pretty standard, actually, from Samsung, even though we don't see the Fizz mid that much.
Well, anyway, you slice it, it's going to be an exciting game. Can Anarchy get the 2-0? It's time to get into game number two and find out. What do you think's written on the stuff next to the Nexus? Just like, be careful, don't destroy this.
Handle carefully.
It's very important. Polish Nexus daily. Welcome once again to Summoner's Rift Anarchy versus Samsung.
You know, the better question is, what exactly does the Nexus do?
It makes, well, no, it doesn't make the minions, because supposedly, like, some, well, actually, I bet now it does make the minions, because before, it was summoners in training that were making the minions. Summoners are gone now.
But who cares? Like, if you're a champion on Summoner's Rift,
kay,
why do I care if my Nexus is destroyed or not?
Because it makes the minions. If you have no minions,
then what?
Then the pushing is going to be, well, then just more of their minions getting your base.
Hey, I'm a champion. I know I'm just infinitely safe in my fountain.
That's true.
Why am I even fighting?
Well, eventually,
I'm basically just safe forever.
I mean, eventually, then just waves of minions start walking into your fountain and you just get unlimited gold. It seems like a way to just become super rich, to let your Nexus die and just sit there. We've actually figured out, we've broken Summoner's Rift, man. That's
that's it.
That's the key. You just let your Nexus go down, let the minions walk in, and live like a rock star. That's right. The problem is Fountain is very small, though. So with five people there, you know, it gets kind of
yeah, but you got a shop next to it. You can get whatever you want.
Instantly. You don't have a bathroom, though.
Well, I don't see any bathrooms anywhere else.
There's no bathroom in Summoner's Rift. There's a lot of bushes, though. So, I mean,
it's okay. Just use Maokai.
Take your pick. If Nasus was in this game, sure. Oh, Snowflower trying to be annoying on this Annie. He's got that stun to try to maybe steal this blue buff. Nope, not going to get it. Smite used, of course. Snowflower being very annoying. Meanwhile, Wraith trying to be irritating as well. They're going to chase him away, though, early on, as Anarchy goes for their blue buff.
Well, they're not going to chase him away quite yet. Both teams.
He's got to be a little bit more careful, though.
Yeah, freezing with their AD carry here. Lane swap coming in again. We don't want Anarchy.
He could have autoed that and taken it. I think he could have.
Oh, really?
Yeah, it was after he pulverized, it had, like, no health.
Well, in any case, doesn't quite get it. And we're going to see the same thing. Corki swapping out of the Kog'Maw lane. I'm not sure what the Yasuo Fizz matchup is like, really. You'd think that would be probably a skill matchup for both sides. I don't really see a reason why it would go in favor of one or the other.
You'd imagine. Now, Ixu was recalling for a while, but he canceled it to just go right to lane. Just feeling the need to get these minions right away, I suppose. And he can heal up, I suppose, off of his Q.
Yeah, it's a small heal, but it'll do something.
Over time, if he avoids the damage, it might work.
Yeah. Well, looks like Fury's just a little bit nervous about getting close to Ixu right now. Just wants to go ahead and freeze this lane right on the next wave, so he's maximizing effectively the amount of distance Ixu has to go out into the lane.
Well, this is going to be an interesting lane to watch. Exhaust on Crown already. He's a little bit behind enemy lines here. The knockup misses. Crown flashes. Here comes Eve. Mickey in a little bit of trouble. Ignite used. Will it finish off Mickey? One tick too short, I think. Yep. Not enough. Lyra gets low as well.
Yeah, Can't quite finish it off, but Eve Italy coming spear. In with a little bit of a counter. Lyra a little bit late to justify the use of that exhaust in the mid lane. Snowflower's here. Snowflower's only level one, though.
Wow, and they're just going to go after this turret. I suppose they can throw a spear and keep
this could get crazy.
Mickey away. Flash over the wall. There's a stun. A crown gets caught underneath the turret. First blood goes to Mickey. They're going to turn it around. Whoops. Nice play by Snowflower.
This series is funny.
I love it. This is my kind of League of Legends.
Yeah, Snowflower sneaking around and actually getting the Flash W off, even though he was only level one at the time. Very confident play. Mickey with the first blood will go back and pick up an Avarice Blade. So in spite of all that back and forth, Samsung tries to push too hard onto the tower itself when they have no idea where anyone was. They didn't even know that Shen was walking up into the mid lane. So.
Yeah, man. That was totally a Dwarves of Moria situation right there. They delved too greedily and too deep.
They did. For not really a lot of benefit either. It's difficult to kill turrets this early in the game. So you're unlikely to get much meaningful damage on it. And it's also not like there's a lot of follow-up. Well, what is Fizz going to do?
Exactly. Do you really want Crown to suddenly have not really good farm opportunities? You kind of just starve him of CS if you do that, right?
Well, it's also the issue of there's no follow-up in terms of tower damage. Like, okay, you put the tower down to 50%. Well, Crown has no wave clear. So is he going to get that turret down over time? Probably not. You're going to need to push at some point with the Nidalee and the Kog'Maw to actually take it down. So it's just not worth the risk, really. If it was a champion that could repeatedly chip this tower against Yasuo, if it was in Azir or something like that, it would make a lot more sense.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, Fizz is generally not going to take a turret by himself in a 1v1 very often.
Yeah, unless you leave him alone in lane with a Sheen or something like that, but that's an avoidable situation.
Or if you just die over and over again and then he gets in there because you're dead, but That's not, if that's happening, it's not a normal game of League of Legends.
Right. At least not at the professional level, I'm sure. No. Many solo, we all have solo queue games where the Yasuo feeds the Fizz in the mid lane.
Oh, yeah. Not a lot of Fizz in the mid lane in the green solo queue anyway that I've seen. Well, at my low elo anyway.
Well, there's not, I think, too much going around right now. We used to see a lot more mid lane Fizz earlier this year. It has cooled off in terms of a trend. It's only a response here.
Oh, yeah.
All right,
oh,
here we go
Mickey
again.
Mickey coming in, getting baited perhaps a little bit. Snowflower there with the stun, though, so they have to be careful. Mickey dodges the spear exhaust, gets pushed back with the pulverize.
Oh,
no
boy.
Headbutt. Oh, man, there goes Crown yet again. And Anarchy finds another kill. Samsung trying to get clever, but it's just not working this game.
And Mickey really did do some very good dodging with the Yasuo, and then that was the dangerous combo that we said. If the Annie and the Rek'Sai are both there in a skirmish and the Annie catches a couple of people with a stun, it is so hard to win that duel. Sure, Eve has some damage, but without that crowd control factor, it's just not quite enough right now. Mickey is going to be level 6 as he goes back to pick up some more items. We'll see if he can. It's going to be too early for the Shiv, but
it's a pretty hugely dangerous situation for Crown now, though, because he's still level 5. Should be able to get level 6 pretty soon. Oh, yeah, he's really close. Never mind.
Yeah, Crown
he's
also has had to kind of itemize into the Seeker's Armguard here. That's another factor against this Yasuo. You don't really want to get that first on a Fizz if you can help it. So, not taking the most ideal. Oh, God, they're coming in again.
No flash still for Crown. Snowflower is still level 3 this game. Keep that in mind. Oh, okay, Crown goes in. Use that playful trickster. Snowflower with no flash, though, to pop the W. That's a little bit ambitious, but does pick up level 4 off the wave at least.
If Mickey had been able to hit a knockup, then they could have chained it into a stun. But
yeah, definitely.
Instead, they're going to go for an invade. If Mickey's able to push the mid lane up, as Crown is having such a difficult time here, and that means that there's a really easy red takeaway from Snowflower and Lyra in the bottom side. So they'll grab it and get out.
Yep. Not a lot that Samsung can do to stop that.
We're back to this. It's good old Camp for Mickey, the Anarchy Classic.
And oh, yeah. Now, meanwhile, Kuvei is a bit ahead in CS of Ixu. That's something at least, but it won't last forever, it looks like.
All right. Well, now that the lanes are swapping back to normal, this camping that's going on the bottom side should end if Samsung plays it right, because they need to start moving their jungle and their support up there to clear out these pink wards that are giving Anarchy the opportunity to play the way they are currently. So that should be high priority. If Samsung just leaves them there, then Snowflower can continue these shenanigans with Lyra. And Ixu's level 6, of course, so having that Shen in the top side, he's got twice the number of globals. And he can come into that mid lane at any time, so the Operation Feed Mickey is proceeding apace here.
And not a bad start. And this top lane is so exciting. Oh, yes.
You just love ninjas hitting trees, don't you?
Oh, yeah. It's practicing, you know?
All right, here we go. Dive coming in, but that will be found out by this pink ward. And here we go.
Oh, yeah. Meanwhile, they will try to take out Kuvei.
Gonna flash. Uh-oh.
Even a little bit of trouble. Fizz ult does not hit Mickey, though. He's going to waltz his way out of there.
They tried to make a play while Mickey was alone, and they knew it. But instead, the only thing Samsung ended up with was losing an ult from Fizz and a flash from Kuvei in the top side. So Anarchy getting important abilities in both lanes.
Yeah.
Here we go. Oh, man,
that was
clever.
They're going to make the play. Yes, right on to Ixu, and they're going to get the knockup after the taunt. Kuvei in a lot of trouble, and he goes down.
No one expects this Shen ult into the Rek'Sai that's already behind you.
Yep.
That was actually a very clever answer, because he may not have been able to get into taunt range without using his flash otherwise, but if using it like that, there's pretty much no way that the Maokai could get out. So
that was a very rare sneaky moment from Shen. Can't see him coming in if he's underground.
Also, yeah, and if the Shen starts ulting and you're Kuvei, you definitely don't expect the Shen to be ulting behind you in your lane. You think he's going somewhere else on the map.
Oh, definitely.
So you're busy warning your lanes instead of thinking about the fact that he's actually making a play on you. That was pretty funny, actually. I haven't seen that before.
Well, now we know. I mean, it seems like a fairly well-thought-out composition by Anarchy. Again, you know, we talked about the benefits that Shen gives Yasuo, too, that maybe makes him a stronger pick than he's been recently.
Yeah, I like this composition better than I like the last one. I don't know. The Fizz, I'm not sure. I don't know enough about Fizz versus Yasuo, I think, to really understand why Crown would pick this into this particular matchup. Mm. Especially since it seems like he just blocked the fish with the wind wall, but...
I don't think it'd be too hard. That's a lot of damage on the Crown right there. And Lyra coming from behind. He's trying to put a little bit of pressure onto this turret. Now, Snowflower is right there as well, too, so they could maybe try to do a bit of a dive, couldn't they?
Yeah, might have an opportunity. They're probably going to wait for the Shen ult to be back up, just so they have a shield during that time where they actually might consider diving. Ixu had to go the Cowl first in the Maokai matchup, but now he's on to his Bami Cinder, so building, of course, into that Sunfire Cape. Long time since Mickey's been back home. Definitely has enough money for that static shift now.
Yeah, I think that's why they're pushing up this lane, just to make sure Mickey can go back. Oh, Fizz ult used onto Lyra, actually, just to try to save the turret, but I don't know if that's really the time you want to use that. Either way, Mickey's going to go back.
Okay, dive coming in.
Oh, nice pulverize right at the end of the Valkyrie, pushing Sangyin back under turret, but Wraith taking a little bit too much turret damage, and Fury and Eve not close enough to make a play.
Yeah, that was, I mean, using the flash, it was a good use of flash from Wraith, but with flash still up on Sangyin, they wasted a lot of resources to try and make that work. Mickey not going to go back. Mickey just going to start carving up the turret with his sword. Wow, this is... very interesting play from Samsung. Trying that dive, it was uncoordinated and unsuccessful, and they just basically, I mean, I guess it's worth it to trade a summoner spell on your support for the AD carry, but when you show your jungle at the same time, that's where it crosses the line a bit. Because by showing the jungle, Mickey knew he could just walk up to that tower and start autoing it.
Right. One of these times, Crown's going to use his playful trickster for wave clear, and then Snowflower's going to be all over him again. I'm waiting for it.
Yeah, and yeah, he I haven't seen his abilities yet, but he probably only has 1 point in Playful Trickster right now.
Yeah.
And that makes it difficult to clear waves. He may have more this game. Oh, he does. He actually has 5 points in it. So,
okay.
Yeah, he has it for the wave clear at the moment. And to make sure that he has it up to dodge what he needs to dodge, considering how hard he's been camped this game.
Well, Mickey getting ulted by Crown. A lot of damage onto him, but he's going to go in anyway. Snowflower can still flash Tibbers, and he does. Eve getting very low. Exhaust onto Mickey immediately.
Yeah, doesn't just last very some long, damage, though. Mickey doesn't actually get the last breath, but by playing aggressively, they will get the turret.
Yeah, and that's a nice little bit of gold. They're already 3K ahead now. And Anarchy starting to build that early lead, just like they did last game.
Well, Anarchy, if you want to play League of Legends with your wacky assassin picks and your mid lane camping, I'm not going to stop you.
Nobody can stop them from doing it. You can stop them from winning with it, but you can't stop them from doing it.
Maybe Samsung can't, actually.
Yeah. Samsung looks like they're really struggling with this. I mean, Crown just does zero damage right now.
Mickey going for the BF sword before he even gets boots here, so just relying on Yasuo's mobility from his kit rather than actually going into any kind of movement speed items. And he's just going for the big combo, the big, big damage. Now, he's not anywhere close, but here comes the split pushing, starting from Mickey as they transfer him into the bottom lane. Timing couldn't be better. After this Dragon Song, you can just recall and move into mid lane with the Trinity Force.
Yeah, so game number one, Samsung got a couple dragons to start things off, but the first dragon of game two goes to Anarchy.
Or he did pick up some boots in the end.
Ah.
Now he is a shod samurai. It's different than a shoddy ninja, which is what Shen is.
That's Shen, yeah.
Subtle difference.
You know, Yasuo is a little bit of a shoddy samurai, though, according to his lore. Nobody really likes him. The general opinion of Yasuo is not good.
What does his lore say about him?
He did something. I can't remember. It's been a while. But he, like, killed somebody he wasn't supposed to kill or something like that. I don't know. Or framed for something, but
I feel like everybody has killed someone they weren't supposed to kill if you're a champion.
That's probably true, yeah.
In fact, everybody is just a horrible mass murderer every game, almost.
Yeah, and you can't even blame the summoners anymore. Oh, there's a knock-up. Exhaust used onto Wraith to slow him down. They really want this kill. Wraith pops his ultimate. Going to be tanky, but there's the last breath. Damage onto Wraith. Man, he's tanky, but Mickey still gets that kill. A little bit of damage on the mid lane turret, though. Songyun and Lyra coming in, and Eve taking a lot. There's a flash for Lyra. He could go for the knock-up here. That's a lot of damage. Songyun doesn't even need it. Oh, boy.
Eve, no flash, so all Songyun has to do is burn that summoner heal and chase Eve all the way back. And here's where it gets real. They're on a Trinity Force power spike. They have a Yasuo split pushing. This Shen could be anywhere on the map at any time. So Anarchy is in prime position just to split push their way to a win. Well, we don't get to see too many split push comps, but we're getting to see two from Anarchy tonight.
Hey, and they're both working really well, too. It seems like they really brought something that Samsung wasn't expecting to see and is certainly not ready to handle.
Well, Samsung did opt into a low wave clear mid laner after losing to a split push in the last game.
It seems like an unwise decision to make.
Well, I thought that about KU Tigers versus SK Telecom yesterday when they decided to pick Kassadin in game two after losing their mid turret early. And you know what? The same thing happened again. So.
What do you know? It's like if you do the same thing in the same situation, the same result occurs. Bizarre.
Yeah, I mean they had a high wave clear mid laner in the last game, and they still managed to lose. But that was more for decision making reasons than the kind of hot water that they're in right now.
Mm.
Especially once Shen actually finishes the Sunfire. Songyun just on a mission of rotations. Get out of here, Ixu. The top lane turret is mine.
Rotation quest. I feel like someday you're going to make a cell phone game and it's going to be called like Rotation Quest. You have to just really click quickly where you want people to go. Oh, Kube goes in on Snowflower with the flash. Snowflower in a lot of trouble. There's a kill for Fury, so for Samsung.
They can do that, but there's nobody in mid lane or in bottom lane to actually stop damage onto a tier two. And guess what? Those people do a lot of damage right now.
Yeah.
So, okay, you get a turret and a kill. That is worth it for the moment. But in the long run, you nearly lose two tier twos. They're going to get severely chipped. So it's a good play right now, but it depends on how Anarchy follows up if it was actually a good play in the long run. Kube has no armor except for Ninja Tabby to deal with Mickey either. So Samsung right now really lacking a good split pusher. And Crown got the Arm Guard and is building into Lich Bane, but that 1,200 gold from the Arm Guard is setting him pretty far behind when it comes to power spikes compared to this Yasuo, who now has some Merc Treads and will likely be building into an Infinity Edge for that massive burst.
Yeah, he's probably fairly close to it at this point, or at least has enough to pick up his pickaxe when he goes back.
I will say I'm a bit surprised that we're not seeing a Blade Yasuo. Typically when you want a split push like this, instead of just hit five people with your ultimate, you're going to be building a Blade. But
Ixu's like, oh, I see a few people on the team.
Everybody was watching him.
Ward successful.
World's worst ninja.
That's true. He was very seen in that particular case. No mystery about that. He thought he was being sneaky, but he failed.
All right, so there's some more siege. Jeez, they're just so far ahead now.
Yeah.
At 20 minutes. And Mickey's going to duel with Kuve under the turret. Shenault goes down, but the actual knockup misses.
Yep.
Ooh, clever.
Yeah, they're going to go and try to sneak a Baron while Anarchy is occupied in this bottom lane. They saw Shenault down there. Why not? Eve getting a little bit low. Teleport coming in for Samsung, though. And now Kuve should be able to tank the rest of this Baron. And it doesn't look like there's anything Anarchy can do to stop this. They may not even be aware it's happening.
No, they're not aware it's happening at all. They certainly are not aware that Kuve just used his teleport to go to the Baron.
That was like right at 20 minutes, too. Now Snowflower's like, hey, where's everybody?
Oh. That was actually quite clever by Samsung. I don't know if that's going to be enough because they're still battling back from a large gold deficit.
Well, they needed to do something, so it was good to see.
And that's Anarchy's fault right there. You can't just invest your entire team down onto the bottom tier two after Baron has spawned without wards on that objective.
Yeah.
Shen still had his teleport. Had he known it was going on, maybe they could have done something right there.
True enough. Well, now Samsung using that Baron to quickly push down this mid lane turret, and it doesn't look like Anarchy has an answer for it. Mickey pushing in top, though. So their answer is to trade turrets, I suppose.
Yep, but without any super minion pressure, Mickey still is going to be the king of the split push. They have to dedicate somebody to doing that. Second dragon going to go over to Samsung again. Not the biggest deal in the world for Anarchy. And again, look at this. They're just going to collapse on the last tier two in the top side. So Anarchy just giving Samsung the run around the map. They may have gotten a Baron, but they're not actually able. They lose a turret and a half in trade for one. And they're still going. Maybe they'll lose two.
Yep, they will.
So a turret and a dragon for two turrets. But one of these teams had Baron. So can they get into mid lane fast enough? They can delay recalls. They may be able to do something with this.
It doesn't look like Wraith's going to find him. Ixu, though, on that causes Songyun to stop it. Snowflower actually canceled his as well.
Yeah, but they got the static shiv Yasuo back, so he should be able to hold mid lane. And Rek'Sai.
Not going to mid lane at the moment, but only Kuve and Fury are there. Well, Fury's going to poke down that turret very quickly. They are actually going to lose this tier two. Mickey went to top lane first, and he should have went to right to mid.
Yeah, that was a nice delay, though.
Yeah.
All the same by Samsung, canceling three of the TPs, which made that defense less appetizing, less appealing to Anarchy. But even so, still, that needle really hasn't moved since the Baron on the gold lead. We're looking at about 5K. And Mickey going to get chased. Shenault goes down.
Yeah, just kind of keep him safe. Are they going to turn onto it, though? Lyra's coming down as well. Eve is right there, though. Ixu and Mickey.
It's maybe some sort of
should be able to get away.
Suicide pact, actually.
I think it's a very elaborate bait by Anarchy. They're going to go right in on the Crown. A lot of damage. Ixu takes him out before Samsung really gets their exhaust onto Fury. And here comes the rest of Anarchy. Lyra right there. He's going to get a nice knockup. They do lose Mickey. And Samsung, they need to kill these Anarchy players really fast, because here comes Snowflower. Flash gets the Tippers down on three of them, and Anarchy still winning this brawl. Songyun enters the fray now, and Kuve, the only one left around, they're going to be able to take him out. Oh, Kuve flashing away from the knockup from Lyra, so he'll be able to make it out too.
Yeah, Twisted Advance, he saw the stun come back up on Annie, so he just Twisted Advance flashes right there, but Anarchy wins a fight, draws them all the way back down, uses that Shen ult, and eventually everybody's able to catch up. But well, Samsung was very grouped, so they're going to lose now an inhibitor turret as a result. I mean, Anarchy's very scrappy. I'm impressed they're actually pulling this off.
Lyra takes Kuve for a ride, but he's going to be able to get out with his tunnels.
Fish.
Uh-oh, Fish ult on him. Crown trying to get his first kill of the game, and that, Lyra very low. Wraith is going to come in and steal it. No kills this game for you, Crown.
Got to steal it with the combo, the Alistar combo.
Make that guy feel bad about picking the mid lane Fizz, I guess.
I mean, Songyun was so far away, but Crown just gets ulted instantly and destroyed. Ixu there trying to do what he can. Now they get the exhaust down onto Fury. That's Mickey's exhaust. So it buys them enough time. And this is where I thought it was going to start going bad, Doa. But it just doesn't, because Snowflower shows up with the three-man Tibbers, and then Songyun appears immediately afterwards.
Ixu very properly tanky in that fight too. It took a long time to even get him low. Now Samsung does find an opportunity to take the tier one in bot lane because of the recalls from Anarchy. So at least they get a turret in response for this. And they're not too far behind. They're 4K at this point, which is dangerous, but
it's extremely dangerous, especially since Mickey was able to get that Infinity Edge in the QSS now. So how do you stop this split push? The TP will be back up soon for Kuve, so that at least is a positive, but you still don't really have the tools necessary to beat out Anarchy unless you get into the Baron pit and actually, if you get in there again without Anarchy warding, maybe, but with this kind of lead, It's just the composition. They don't have that burst from Victor this time around. And if Fizz gets caught out by this Yasuo first, it's pretty problematic. And we saw Crown could just be one shot there.
Indeed. Only that Lich Bane, really, to speak up for Crown. I mean, he's got his Seeker's Armguard, but that provides pretty minimal defense and offense at this point.
Yeah, he's severely under-itemized. You take a look at that, you're looking at one core item compared to three completed on Yasuo right now. So a massive disparity in terms of the gold. Probably that entire gold lead is almost all of it's going to be between Fizz and Yasuo.
I like the bloodthirsty justice from Wraith, though. He's like, you know what? You don't deserve to kill this game, Crown.
There we go.
Oh, Mickey trying to do a little bit of split pushing on this inhibitor as the rest of his team goes to mid and top. And Samsung trying to make a play onto it. Mickey going to get knocked up by that Pulverize. He's going to turn right onto Fury, though. A little bit dangerous as Lyra comes over the wall. Kuve pops his ult. Going to go in onto Mickey with that Twisted Advance, but Lyra's right there to zone with the knockup. Here comes Snowflower with another big Tibbers Sun. Exhaust onto Mickey's going to back out of the fight for a moment, but Samsung player's already going down. Or never mind, actually, Ixu goes down. In that case, Samsung player's getting a kill, but they're going to lose the inhibitor.
Yeah, barely. Kuve barely getting out of that, but still, he's going to try
to Kuve trying to flank, and Crown coming from the side. Kuve gets exhausted immediately. Fury doing a lot of damage from the back line, so there's a kill for him. Lyra trying to come on to him there. Finally a kill for Crown in the mid lane. Songyun doing damage, but the double kill comes in for Crown, and Samsung is actually going to find an ace here as they take out Eve. Goodbye, and Fury with the triple that fight.
Now they can go directly to the Baron. Kuve is just zipping out of base with those home guard boots, so they were able to turn it around. Kuve gets back in, and he punishes them with that home guard teleport flank onto the back line. So can they get another Baron? This is what they need to get back into this game. They've almost equaled it up in terms of gold. They will have after the Baron dies. So Samsung, are they over the hump? Do they have enough tankiness now to survive this Yasuo?
Could be. I mean, they've also lost their bottom inhibitor, but if they just push bottom lane with that Baron, maybe they can just go right back.
Yeah, it's still going to be tough. So let's take a look at this. Ixu already dead, so it is actually going to be a 5v4, which is one of the major problems, but it was a good engage there by Wraith. Gets the knockup, and without any ultimate left onto Mickey. He's not particularly useful. He still doesn't have any kind of armor penetration in spite of the fact that he's against a Frozen Heart and Azonia's Hourglass now.
Right. Samsung able to muscle their way into the Dragon Pit as well, too, and picking up a second dragon isn't the most amazing thing in the world at this point in the game, but it certainly does help.
Yeah, Anarchy going back. They know they have the sideways under control. It's much better for Mickey just to go out and push this top wave and nullify the Baron buff than it is to commit to a second dragon.
Not a ton of wards in that bottom jungle. It looks like Mickey's going to be able to scout things out a bit. Anarchy moving in. They need to kind of provide the means for Mickey to split push here. It's suddenly become a very close game.
Yes, it has, but again, this may be a Baron that Samsung really can't do very much with because they're constantly on the defensive. Every time Anarchy does something, they get a slight more advantage. Sure, the gold is evened up, but just the pressure on the map and the fact that Samsung is going to have to play the rest of this game against a split-pushing Yasuo or Shen on their inhibitor means that they're always going to be playing in a reactive manner.
Yeah. It's not often that you see a team take two Barons by 30 minutes and not be able to use really either of them.
Well, split pushing is powerful if done right.
It certainly is. Lyra just taking more of Samsung's jungle. Not having too much of a problem there.
Yeah, we're just kind of waiting, Anarchy right now, just waiting for this Baron to run its course. And we can see what their game plan is after that. Probably just going right back to splitting. And actually looks like a BT next for Mickey. So no concern whatsoever with any kind of arm penetration. Here we go.
Oh, yeah, knock up on the Sanyu. They have an opportunity. Crown gets the ult, gets the kill. Gets out. For now, he's got that Zonya's Anarchy's going to try to finish him off, but he playful tricksters away. Meanwhile, Wraith in the middle of the fight. Mickey tries to get the kill, but gets taken out by Fury. And Samsung is starting to look a little bit too strong for the scrapping of Anarchy. That's a double kill now for Fury, taking some turret hits. And meanwhile, Eve finds Ixu on his own. Can he get the spear? Misses it. Ixu very low, though. Looks like he'll live for now, but their inhibitor is not going to, so wow. Spears are going to make it very hard for Ixu to recall right now.
Well, can they actually finish, though? Their Nexus turrets are under threat at the moment, and Ixu is still alive.
Baron has ran out, though. Here comes Ixu coming back again with that home guard. A little bit dangerous. Lyra gets low. Lyra gets taken out by Fury yet again.
He's back.
Oh, boy. Songyun back. Yeah, they have to back away. They get one inhibitor turret, but that's going to have to be enough for Samsung.
And Samsung playing it right. You see that split push going down with Mickey. He can't be back instantly like the Shen can. Just go ahead and dive that. And Songyun way too far forward, gets caught out nearly instantaneously and gets the hurt down on it. Mickey only ulted an ulting Alistar in that fracas underneath his turret. So he had a very poor last breath. And then the Shen ult too went on to Lyra for some reason. It's kind of a very uncoordinated fight from Anarchy in terms of target selection and how to use their abilities.
How about the synergy between Wraith and Crown this game, too? I mean, Wraith is really single-handedly getting Crown back into the game by providing opportunities for him to get kills. Yeah. Even though he did steal that one, he's made it up to him.
I agree. Wraith is having a very nice game.
Yeah.
He's been setting up a lot of the plays that have been made for the comeback. He got that really big pull earlier in the bottom side. And now they're up an inhibitor, so looking good for Samsung.
Yeah, Samsung's bottom inhibitor has respawned, so they do have the advantage in the super minion department.
All right, looks like they're going to try and make a pick here. Everybody just stacking in a brush, but there's no Baron. Seems unlikely that Samsung's actually going to face check into that side of the jungle. They have so many tools, too. They have a Nidalee Spear they can go ahead and check with. Wraith has his ultimate up, so he's going to be pretty much immune to picks.
They may still find someone here, though, with this blue buff.
Maokai's,
no wards, though.
Maokai's in bottom. They haven't. If they can kill somebody quickly enough,
they've got the Tremor Sense to see where Samsung is.
Samsung just has to be careful not.
Oh, here they go. Yeah, no wards for Samsung. Uh-oh. They're going to try to go in. Righteous Glory activated right onto Fury is the pick. Fury gets a bit low. Huge knockup by Wraith, though. Is that going to save his AD carry? Looks like it won't as Mickey comes in with the last breath. Kill goes to Lyra in the end, though. More knockups. coming down, Crown on the exterior of the fight, trying to make something happen. Another big knock up onto Samsung, and this is quite the fight. Crown manages to pick off the support on the Anarchy side. Lyra doing work before he finally gets taken down, and it looks like in the end, Samsung barely takes the fight as Iksu on the run, the only member of his team left alive. That was about as even as it gets, but Wraith with a headbutt pulverized. Nope, not going to be able to close the distance as Iksu taunts away.
Yeah, he's just delaying him, though, because there are super minions going into his base at the moment, but Sangyun will be back up in about 10 seconds.
Well, the question is, when is Kuvei's Righteous Glory going to be back up? Wraith is still chasing. Oh, he's going to not find him. Wow, what a fight. So, pretty even scrap between the two teams there.
Yeah.
In the end, Samsung coming out a little bit ahead again.
Again, we just didn't see the best protection for Sangyun. And Wraith has had these huge pulverizes this game, honestly. He has been Wraith here. Because if we take a look at this, they get onto Fury immediately, but watch. Huh. Huge, huge knockup courtesy of Wraith. And that means Crown can get back onto Sangyun in addition to Eve.
Yeah, it was really all the focusing that Fury got that fight that allowed Crown to do a ton of damage.
Yeah. And Crown really did go off at the end. He just barely died right here, too, to Iksu. If he had stayed up in this battle, it could have been a little bit different. Even if Eve had stayed alive, maybe they could do something more. Another dragon looks like it will be rapidly dying.
Yeah, third one for Samsung, and that's making it a little bit dangerous for Anarchy as far as the dragon stacks go as well, too. And Samsung has really performed a great comeback this game.
Well, this is also why these split push compositions have that risk, because you get past a certain point and you could just get dove.
Yep.
If it's not your top laner who's splitting, if you are trying to run a 1-3-1, which is the kind of composition that Anarchy has tried to run in both of these last two games, sure, they put a lot of pressure on the enemy's team's shot calling and decisiveness, but once you get that decisiveness, you can force the 5v5s or the turret dives that you need to take a win.
Oh boy, Baron activated by Samsung, and it looks like Anarchy doesn't like that. Mickey gets exhausted, gets jumped on. Can he make a play here? Last Breath comes in. Snowflower able to get the kill on Crown, and that is not good for Samsung. Anarchy found the fight they want, and Iksu getting into the back lines. Ooh, big knockup from Wraith yet again, going to give his life to save his team. It's a double kill for Snowflower, and he getting bloodthirsty, and Anarchy going for this Baron. As Snowflower goes back to base, a leisurely trip after a nice team fight from Anarchy.
And Mickey hit the first really good ult he's actually managed to get this game in that team fight, because he was the one really initiating right there while Crown and Kuvei were caught a bit unaware, and now they have that Baron buff. They're coming back down the mid lane. Easily able to take that. They have a huge amount of damage between Corki and Yasuo to quickly take these objectives to go down. Are they going to commit to the second inhib, though? Because everyone's going to be back up. I'm not sure that's a good idea.
Well, Snowflower should be able to just barely get there if Anarchy can delay this fight, but Righteous Glory Use are going to go right in. Flash engage onto Mickey. Nice knockup again. Headbutt pulverized by Wraith. And Samsung really looking to turn this one around. They killed Mickey so fast, and they're going to get Lyra as well. A kill for Kuvei. And now who else can they chase down? Crown trying to find Snowflower. He's not going to quite hit him with the ultimate, though.
I don't know why you would go for that second inhibitor. It is so greedy when they were all coming back up. You know that they're going to be running out with Homeguard, so they're going to try and actually use the Baron-empowered minions to split push this. Two people on defense right now, but it's a lot of time for Samsung to work with.
Yeah, going to be an inhibitor down in the mid lane, and they've got a while until Lyra and Mickey come out. They want to end it. There's only one inhibitor or one Nexus turret remaining. Iksu, Snowflower, Sangyun, all that stands between Anarchy and a loss here. Wraith goes in for another knockup. Crown really poking away at that turret. There it goes. They're going after the Nexus now. Mickey up in 4 seconds. It's going to be close, but Crown is on the Nexus, and nobody's stopping him. Double kill for Eve at the same time, and there it is. They get the Nexus, and we are all tied up. Crown takes it out. So, did you really expect anything different?
No, I did not, Toa. This is what I expected, but
yeah.
I mean, it was a nice comeback from Samsung. They came back from a huge deficit, realized that if they just grouped and dove when the split push was coming in, that Mickey would no longer be a threat because they had the tankiness to survive that. But even so, Anarchy definitely could have given them the runaround there. They had the Baron. They took out an inhibitor. At that point, you could just split push come back with actually five people with the Baron buff or split push, you're even more in that situation. Keep your Shen on the top side while four people go bottom. Pretty big misplay to end that game for Anarchy.
Yep, but that means we're going to game number three. Samsung's right. It's time for game number three between Anarchy and Samsung. Picks and bans. There's the Azir ban. Crown's not going to get to play it today.
No, but, you know, Crown has a very large champion pool, so yeah. I don't know if the Azir ban is really that problematic. Obviously,
both of these mid laners do, really.
Mickey can't play it very well. There's a Rumble, so same bans for Anarchy as in game one on the red side. And then, actually, they're switching up. Kalista's open for the first time in a while.
Yeah, no kidding. And will they grab that for Songyun? I feel like it wouldn't be the worst idea, but it's not really the type of champion that Anarchy would play.
The last time I remember Anarchy playing Kalista, Songyun got dove repeatedly under his turret while it was the Ku Tigers game.
Oh, yeah.
And Snowflower was roaming around the map, and Ku was just saying, well, we're just going to dive the Kalista now, and he sat there and died a bunch. So
that's the thing. I mean, they do identify. They do go with the Kalista, but it is a smart thing to identify that Snowflower is a big-time roaming support, and that's not really the best kind of player you want to pick a Kalista as a lane partner with.
Yes, you need your support there to actually trade effectively off your W, off the Sentinel.
Yeah.
And if you're left alone, your ult doesn't do much.
Or anything.
Or anything.
I think it's going to be Alistar.
And so here's the Alistar to dive the Kalista. It's coming, though.
Alistar Maokai.
No,
the Gragas is up, too. I forgot about that. Wow. Yeah. Gragas. Oh, boy.
The doom of Songyun.
Well, I think Samsung may have baited Anarchy pretty hard with this Kalista pick.
There's Lyra wondering why his Gragas was taken.
Wondering why his team pick Kalista instead of a champion they'll actually be able to use. We'll see. Anything can happen in the game, as we have come to expect from these two teams, but we'll see. Now, Rek'Sai is also available, too, if they want to go for that. But they're going to go with the Eve, and it's going to be the Fizz this time. Ixu did have a pretty awesome game on Fizz in game number one.
But there isn't a top laner that they've actually shown.
That does make it a little bit awkward. It could go to Mickey. It could go to Mickey.
Let's just assume, because of Mickey's playstyle, that he can play Fizz quite well.
Yeah,
that wouldn't
I'm
surprise
sure.
me in the least. So they may try and flex it. Also, Maokai is a... You look at this composition, you're like, well, there's probably going to be a Maokai coming in here from Samsung. I like the Evelynn pick, because when you see the possibility of a dive onto Songyun's Kalista, well, if you're playing Evelynn, they may not exactly know where you are. That may make them a bit more tentative. Of course, the Shen, another champion that can dive the bottom lane. Let's do it. Everybody just pile into the bottom lane.
Do dive, and it may be this Shen and Kog'Maw. Fury obviously having a pretty awesome game on Kog'Maw last game, doing a great job auto-attacking and stealing the MVP from Wraith.
Well, huge front line with the Shen added for this Kog'Maw to peel.
Yeah. We've actually seen a Kog'Maw every game tonight.
Cogs galore.
That's right. Cog many. Cog moused? No, I don't know.
Try again. All right, the TF for Mickey, so it will be a top lane Fizz. Now, this is one of the rare times since the Cinder Hulk Fizz went out of style that we're seeing a Fizz in the top lane without a Maokai being there.
Yeah. I think they're really... I wonder what they're expecting Crown to play here in the mid lane.
Well, Anarchy just going to go for a 1-3-1 composition again, except this time they lack the Siege in the mid lane. The Kalista not the best for holding a Siege in mid by yourself, of course.
Well, there's no wave clear. Like
unless you build Hurricane.
Yeah, that's true. Okay, but you need to get fairly close to make that work, and it looks like it's going to be Victor for Crown. Yeah, okay.
So we get to see the Victor TF match up for the same time. Both Samsung and Anarchy going to be replaying the same mid laners that they had in the first game of this series. You know, it did go well for Crown for a while, but Mickey found a way to be slippery on the map and pull. You know, they pulled out the victory in the end. So if they can hold a little bit better, wait for their scaling, the same problems are going to be applying this time. Kalista has to get very close, and Victor will be able to burst her down as well as Twisted Fate. So a lot of squishy champions again being fielded by Anarchy. They have to maintain a 1-3-1. Late game team fighting will go to Samsung.
You know, Snowflower did get Thresh too, and we've seen him make a lot of plays on that champion in the past, so it's certainly a comfort pick for him that hadn't mentioned yet, so that might help Rebels Anarchy as well, but we will see. It's been a close series, it's been an exciting series, but it all comes to an end right now as one of these two teams will take the win here in game number 3. I like it, though. It's been kind of like a throwback series, the strategies of of yore.
Of season 3.
That's right.
Except for Victor. He's new.
That's right. He was around back then. He just wasn't used. So, it is time. Game number 3, Anarchy versus Samsung. Who takes it? Let's find out. All right. Welcome Summoner's Rift. An exciting series, a down and dirty brawl between Anarchy and Samsung Galaxy. And we make it to game number 3. And I would imagine this one's going to be just as action-packed. I hope it is.
I think we're guaranteed that. We have a Twisted Fate. We have a Fizz coming in. Anarchy has to make attempts at all ends if they want to take this game home.
How does Fizz do against Shen in the top lane,
do
you think?
I don't know. This is a new matchup. Shen versus the Trinity Force Fizz. I mean, I would assume it would be very similar to how he does against Maokai, just because you're going to have that percent HP.
Yeah.
And you can dodge the crowd control effect, so you can Playful Trickster out of either Taunt or the Twisted Advance.
True enough.
And Shen may be able to return a bit more damage to you with the Vorpal Blades if you stay in a continuous trade, but I would still think this would be a perfectly fine matchup for Fizz.
Should
the
be.
Problem is that you are not really able to stop the Stand United, right? You have to throw your fish down, and that's going to take some time before you get the knockup, so unless you hit the fish very quickly, you probably are not going to be able to stop Shen from actually getting into another lane.
Would you say Shen's healing off of his Q is less than Maokai's healing off his passive?
That all
depends. Who do you think sustains better?
I don't know the exact numbers on Vorpal Blade, so that'll depend also on how many spells are used in the lane, which depends on things like mana regen. Does Maokai buy a Catalyst and a second Doran's Blade, which is usually what we see him do.
Right.
So it's difficult to say because it's so dependent on how many auto attacks Shen is able to get off versus how many spells are cast in between auto attacks for Maokai. So I'm not sure you can actually definitively lay that one down.
Yeah, it's going to be interesting. Another fun matchup in the mid lane, Mickey's Twisted Fate versus Crown's Victor. So some interesting picks for Anarchy. I like it. And the big question is, you know, what's going to happen to this Kalista down in bot lane? You know, is Samsung going to completely raffle stomp it like we've seen Sangyun's Kalista suffer before?
Well, at the very least, we can see he has the early edge. This time, just pushing forward aggressively, forcing Fury and Raid back.
And if Fury can't keep up on CS, that's going to really hurt Samsung's chances in the later parts of the game. He's always going to have time to come back, but it is much easier for a Kog'Maw if you're at least able to stay even. He's going to get the good amount of farm under turret now, though.
Yeah, he evens himself right back up within one after that wave, so not a big issue so far. And it's going to come down to a lot to Eve and what he can do in conjunction with Kuve for these ganks. And
it's rare when we see a Gragas pick get through these days.
Yeah, banned out most of the time, but we've seen it twice tonight already.
True enough.
And Kuve just hanging way, way back. One nice thing, too, about this Shen, that having that MR per level now does help him a lot in terms of these AP top lane matchups. Sure, the Fizz will be building into more attack damage, but still the natural magic damage from his abilities. Threatening.
Eve coming in. They might get a flash out of Mickey, and it looks like they do. Eve flashing for that as well. I feel like he could have just. Do you think he could have just body slammed and gotten Mickey to flash anyway?
No, he's too far away. Mm. So tried to get that out, but it's still a worthwhile trade. Crown now has that edge in terms of summoner spells and has the cleanse. So if he wants to go all in later on, Mickey again tanking this ignite.
Yeah, Lyra able to steal the Gromp from Eve. Eve is Grompless.
It's always a terrible feeling to be Grompless.
I know. You just feel so helpless when you're Grompless.
No way to return damage on things that are attacking you.
It's like, great, now I gotta buy a Thornmail. Oh. Thornmail Gragas. Hidden OP.
Well, there's a ward there.
Yeah, I don't think this lane gank's gonna work too well.
Missed that ward was placed in the brush. Trinket ward actually from Sangyun. And Gragas waiting a real long time for a gank that has no chance of success, really. But Samsung may be able to buy a little bit of time as they just bounce the wave. And Gragas may not have cared if he was seen, just trying to offer some additional help as they push the lane forward, cover their rear.
It does give the Samsung bot lane a chance to go back and buy.
As you see right there, the Kalista, when Anarchy plays it, is 1-2 so far. It's pretty big. I mean, for a champion that we see banned out every game, it seems almost, that is a pretty large differential. Even though it's only a 3-game sample size, you expect more wins with such a priority champion. Especially when teams like SK Telecom have been able to pull off these 100% win rates.
Yep.
Or players like OQ can absolutely dominate a game.
Yeah, OQ, who we will see in our second matchup when Najin takes on IM after this game is concluded. Don't think they're going to give OQ Kalista, though. It's a pretty bad idea.
Right here looking for the gank.
Yeah, flash headbutt doesn't get the pulverize as he exhausts onto Mickey anyway. Here comes Eve, throws in the barrel. Lyra, a little bit of damage onto him. Mickey's in a lot of trouble. Crown goes down, though, as Mickey manages to get that first kill, and he's still alive. Whoa, Eve tries to come in with the body slam, doesn't connect, and talk about scrappy, man. Mickey comes out with that first blood yet again.
Well, it's just these little things with Samsung where they're slightly more uncoordinated on these ganks in the early game. Wraith was seen inside the Raptor pit, and that gave, and Anarchy was just all there faster. Plus, you have the ignite advantage in that mid lane, so there's just insufficient burst onto Crown to actually kill Mickey quickly with very few items in his inventory. And there's also no follow-up damage from Eve. He's just got nothing yet, just a Ranger's Trailblazer, so you're not going to get much out of it. And Wraith, too, with the exhaust instead of the ignite, as we usually see on these Alistars, but that creates further problems.
Now, I feel like in game number one, Anarchy really forced Samsung to play their game. You know, they forced them to try to be a skirmishing team when Samsung really isn't a skirmishing team right now.
Yeah, they haven't been playing the Twisted Fate in a while.
Yeah.
Earlier this season, definitely, I would say that was a strong point of theirs, but they've been shying away from that particular mode of play.
Right. It was very close, though. Could have easily been Crown getting that first blood, too.
Well, that's, however, not what you want, because now Mickey has first blood, he has a Sheen, and he has his ultimate too, so kind of opening up the map to him.
Yep.
And Sangyun actually will be going for a Hurricane first. Very rare build to see in Korea, but something that is, I think, the right build in this situation. If you want to 1-3-1 with Kalista, you must get the Hurricane.
Well, like you said, you just need that wave clear. Otherwise, you're just going to lose turrets when the split pushing begins for your team.
Can't have that.
Nope. Snowfire is going to try to make a play here. Gets the grab onto Wraith. That's going to be some trading. Gets a flay in as well, too. Wraith getting a bit low. TF coming down to try to finish it off. Gets the gold card onto Fury, though. Ignite used by Snowflower. Wraith had to...
Oh, wow.
Oh, wow.
So they got
just teleporting her back up.
They got Kuve's port, and then he's just going to TP right to the tower because he doesn't want to lose too much when it comes to his actual experience. But that means that there's now a TP advantage for Iksu, and they can go for this dragon right now, honestly.
Yeah.
Iksu gonna take a Krug instead, but you have more pressure than that. You can actually just walk up and do the dragon if you want to.
We're gonna hand the blue buff off to Crown here. Yeah, I'm a little bit surprised that Anarchy's not going for the dragon right now. Looks like they just want to invade the top jungle and take as much from Samsung as they can.
I mean, that's okay, but I think you have a chance to really take a lot more.
And they need to. They need to take a lot in this early game with this composition. It's really similar, I suppose, to what we saw in game number one.
And two. I mean, it's all these comps from Anarchy have been quite similar in their desire to 1-3-1, except last game, Anarchy had a little bit more of a front line with that Shen. Mm. This time, not so much. But they also have that big lane bully in the Kalista, although not too far, terribly far behind now, and Ixua really hasn't been able to zone Kuvei off of much CS, even though he popped both of his globals. So Gragas wants to come up into top lane right now. Ixu only has that Sheen.
Could be dangerous. Yeah, Ixu going in, uses that playful trickster. Uh-oh, here comes Gragas. Ixu uses his ultimate, gets Kuvei low, but there's a headbutt. Nice barrel from Eve, and that's going to be a dead Fizz as Eve picks up a kill for his team. Ixu is baited pretty hard there.
Yep, and without that flash, that's what can happen.
Yep.
So Kuvei tries to bait out that all in. One thing I didn't mention actually with the Shen is what's important too is that Maokai tends to itemize glory first, whereas Shen goes immediately into armor and resists, which really does help a lot more. So considering that he is going to be picking up a Sunfire cape early and then he can go straight into MR against the Fizz, he doesn't have to wait quite as long as Maokai does to be relevant in the 1v1. Because Maokai really does need, just for his role, to get onto the enemy team, he does have to have that Righteous Glory.
Well, in the meantime, let me keep pushing that lane up to the turret. A little bit down on CS at the moment, but he has moved around the map a little bit more than Crown, so that's not too surprising. He has had that level 6 for a little while now. So I'm wondering when we're going to see the Gate of Destiny come in here for Anarchy. Maybe around this next dragon. Although, no teleport for either top laner, so it's going to be a 4v4. Well, Shen can come down, though. Oh, Eve goes back in with the body slam, gets hit with the gold car. A little bit dangerous going in there as Lear puts down his ultimate from Evelynn. Eve taken out. Shen comes into the fight. Looks like the both junglers are going to go down. Mickey getting a ton of damage in, though. And Anarchy's going to leave it at that. So both teams lose their junglers. Ult burned by Kuvei, though.
Yeah, and... but Anarchy's going to get the better end of this deal. Right now in the top lane, they're getting a ton of Fizz auto attacks with that Sheen down onto the objective. So even though Anarchy playing a little bit fast and loose when they didn't have a global ability, the burst was enough to net them a trade. And Ixu should be able to slowly whittle down this tower and keep Kuvei using his abilities.
He's gotten quite a bit of damage done to it already. Not too bad at all. Man, Mickey looked like an AD carry that last fight, the way he just kind of sat in the back lines and just did damage.
Well, he's got that Sheen. He is doing quite a bit of damage at the moment, especially in his sustained fight.
Oh, Flay does not hit Wraith. Wraith, though, pulled in by that Death Sentence teleport coming down, though. Sangyun's going to pull him in to help Thresh escape. Can he get the Lantern there in time? Oh, Sangyun pulled out the Lantern by the taunt, I think. Meanwhile, Exhaust goes down onto Sangyun. Wraith trapped in the box a little bit. Nice Death Sentence onto Fury, but can they get anything out of it? Not quite. Mickey coming down, though. Could be big. Gold card onto Wraith. A little bit of damage added onto that. With Fury zoning, it's a bit too dangerous to come in. Ah, an even Crown coming down from the mid lane. So a bit of a fight. Nobody dies, and Ixu continues to push that top lane. He may just be able to take top turret with this.
Yeah, that was actually that fight. I believe it was Wraith headbutting Sangyun out of the Lantern in the end to keep him there.
Yeah.
So Samsung turns that around, or tries to, one more time. This time they have the TP advantage. Again, Ixu has nothing. It is so dangerous for Anarchy to continue to try to make these plays, but somehow they are getting away with it every time.
Now, I would have thought Ixu would have just taken out the turret there.
I don't know. Yeah, he could just push it in on this next one. I think he wants to just push the wave back, just bounce it off the tower.
Just deny as much CS potentially to Kuvei as he can, I suppose.
Well, you just don't want it to freeze right at the tier 2.
Yeah.
Because when you have two, basically there's no problem for Samsung to do that because you can just freeze right at tier 2 And with two globals, there's pretty much nothing you can do. It's not like if Fizz goes elsewhere on the map that Shen can't show up there at any time and keep on doing that multiple times in a row before you get your TP back up again. So a freeze in this situation is particularly dangerous to Anarchy.
Zixu will prolong that lane as long as he can, but looks like it's going to go down now. Yeah, there it goes. And nice little gold lead for Anarchy, about 2k up here at 14 minutes. Still no one with the dragon yet. Oh, they're going to try to make a play onto Kuve there. Gold card onto him. Ixu comes in. Doesn't hit the fish, though, and everyone knocked back by Eve's ultimate. Kuve is still very low, though. And there's a flash gold card. Lyra picks up the kill off of the stun from Mickey.
So baiting that out right there, left a few minions in the wave. Kuve goes up to tank them, doesn't respect the gate coming in.
Wow, it looks like another 2v2 here for Songyun in the bot lane, but Snowflower gets poked pretty hard. Can't do a lot with it.
TP up, Kuve has his ultimate Stand United ready and waiting. Once he's going to respawn, but until then, Ixu does have that global advantage. So Anarchy once again pulling out to an early lead. They're doing well so far. Not exactly what they need to handle this late game team fighting composition that Samsung has brought to bear.
Well, it's been so close all three games. I mean, Anarchy just barely got what they needed in game number one, and they're on track to, you know, if they get it, barely get what they need in game number three too. They barely didn't get what they needed in game number two.
Yeah, very interesting that we haven't seen any dragons here. And when we talk about snowballing these games and actually coming to the point of victory, having that dragon threat of 4 to 5 stacks can be pretty crucial.
Well, Mickey can just go ahead and take out the Rift Scuttler. And we'll see what he gets when he goes back. He's already got a couple items.
And Sanya going with a bit of a weird build here. Went recurve bow into BF sword. Not sure what's going on there. Just apparently wants the extra little bit of damage.
Well, it's interesting because he hasn't exactly been feeling the pressure to go for like a Bloodthirster this game, but I think it must be, like you said, just for the damage. It does delay the Ruin's Hurricane, but in this extended laning phase, I suppose you can afford to do that.
Yeah, he's not having any trouble when it comes.
Grab onto Eve. Yeah, they can't really follow that up, though.
Yeah, too many people. Twisted Fate is pushed out.
Yeah.
Don't want to use that ultimate. And Ixu does have the TP, but with Kuve, Stand United can add that shield, so it does mean a little bit of an edge in the global competition.
True enough. Kuve trading pretty well so far with Ixu anyway. I could really use that Ruin's Hurricane in the next few minutes here. Ixu has a lot of wards in the top, so he can push pretty safely here. I feel like Samsung really wants to try to set up a dragon if they can. If nothing else, just to take the pressure off the map.
Yeah, well, they don't really have, I mean, they have to go at it from the mid lane. They have the blue buff now. Can Lyra and Crown get into the river to take it will be the question, because they definitely are not going to be able to push up that bottom wave particularly quickly at the current point in time. They may have found an opportunity, though, with this Kalista recalling.
Well, Dragon gets grabbed, gets a bit of damage onto Samsung. They're just going to go for it. Okay.
Yeah, there's no Kalista. It definitely can.
Yep. Why not? And so it looks like Samsung will take a pretty clean first dragon here.
Yep, and there's the gate. Gonna make a play on the top side.
Yep, trying to take out Kuve again. He does have flash this time. Fizz grabs him with the ultimate. Kuve trying to Stand United away. Can they get him in time? They can.
Oh, that stack deck passive hit him with that last auto attack to make sure they got that kill, but Samsung isn't done. They want to turn onto the mid lane tier one.
And they'll get it too. So the gold lead staying pretty even. And now that Hurricane done for Songyun, so he can start to push these lanes pretty hard if he wants to. He's got the wave clear.
Yeah, good on Samsung, though, to take out that mid lane, because now TF has to walk up very far, Kalista, both of whom are very vulnerable to getting all in by the Alistar, the Gragas. So this is a nice way to keep their own mid lane tower up, even as their bottom turret gets quite low. So this should slow down Anarchy.
It should. And slowing down Anarchy is exactly what Samsung needs to do this game, as much as possible.
Yeah, and this time it's not so bad compared to game one. They're only 2.5K down. Kuve is just happy to sit here, go ahead, take all this farm, slow push it all the way back out. Victor can keep on controlling the Twisted Fate, keep him back in his lane, because now that TF has to farm back by his tier two, it takes him even longer to TP up to the top or the bottom sides of the map. Especially since those towers aren't down yet, so nobody's going to be split pushing from the Samsung side very deep into that side. So he's in a pretty bit of a tough position right now until he swaps out and maybe can play a little bit more forward in bottom lane.
Well, the Gate of Destiny is almost up again for Mickey, so we'll see if Anarchy has a play in mind to use that.
Gate's up, but
yep.
No one really wants to play around right now with the bottom side. Samsung's been very aggressively controlling vision. Look how many pink wards they have. They don't want Songyun moving up and taking out this tower, which just has a tiny amount of HP left on it.
Lyra coming mid. It's a very tense lull in the action here. Oh, never mind. I spoke too soon. Knock up onto Songyun. There's the exhaust as well. Snowflower can do nothing to save his teammate. And Fury gets his first kill of the game. Kuve tries to come in with the taunt. There's the Gate of Destiny to see if they can catch Crown. Flash Gold card will do it. And Mickey will help Lyra pick up yet another kill. Samsung responding, though, by taking out this bottom turret. So they do get something in exchange for the 1-1. Oh, but they're going to lose their mid lane, too.
Yeah, so trading just perfectly evenly effectively, but that's just fine for Samsung. Trading evenly now is actually good for them.
Will it be even though? Because a couple of Sheens is going to mean that this turret's going to fall very, very quickly, but the minion wave not cooperating.
Yeah, they just they lost most of their minions on that tier one, so they couldn't push it all the way through into a tier two. And now just back to freezing in top for Kuve. Want to hold on to that wave with the, well, as best as he can, at least with the Sunfire Cape, and Crown having a bit of a tough game, but was isolated by Lyra and Mickey in that last one, had to try and fight the 2v1.
Yep. I mean, we saw Crown have a really tough game on Fizz at the beginning of last game. He started out 0-3-0 in lane and ended the game 5-6-7 due to some nice setups by Wraith, so could get turned around.
Yeah, he bounced back well.
Yeah.
And it's hard to play against a Twisted Fate and an Evelynn. Of course, you can't always know when they are, where they are, so Songyun will take the red buff, but the Operation Dive Songyun is working to this point. He's now close to that Bloodthirster, which is a huge power spike for Kalista. Bloodthirster, with the Rudin's Hurricane in the mid-game, is a very powerful combination to start fighting. And it should be done by the time this dragon goes down. Kuve and Ixu is trading, but actually Ixu not doing too hot there.
Kuve gets the turret. There's the gate used. Wraith in a lot of trouble either way. Nice play by Snowflower to keep him in there, and Mickey with another kill. A lot of trouble for Wraith this game.
Yeah, Wraith really using his ultimate quite late.
Yeah. Now the split push from Ixu going pretty well at this point.
Look at all the wards coming in now from Anarchy around the Baron. They really want to be able to threaten this. They have Sentinels patrolling the objective too. They got that early Baron, or Samsung rather, got the early Baron in the last game.
Yep.
We'll see if Anarchy can replicate that feat. Samsung, no wards right now for that.
You know, we've been seeing Snowflower make the plays too on this Thresh. I mean, there's a reason why it's kept away from him a lot of games, and I think we've seen a pretty good example of that so far this game.
Yeah, absolutely. He's shown up, gotten a couple of assists, but mostly just done his job as his laning partner did get a lot more damage on that turret for the most part. But still, we do see Fury starting to ramp up. He's been given a lot of this empty lane farm right now. He really is beginning to get scary as he narrows down onto that Blade of the Ruined King. Three people from Samsung up. Looks like they don't even want to contest this dragon whatsoever.
If Samsung is going to win this game, this is where they're going to have to start winning it. And Anarchy is going to be able to take this mid lane tier 2 without any trouble at all.
Yeah, they had four people in the top side for some reason, and that's really heavily punished. Anarchy just gets a turret for free.
Yeah, and they can just go right down to this dragon, too, if they want to. Yeah, meanwhile, turret does go down in top lane.
With Mickey down in the bottom side and also Gate not up, they really don't have to commit that many people into the top side of the map to be safe. Only need a couple under these particular circumstances, so they trade a tier 1 for a tier 2, but Anarchy also going to pick up the dragon.
Yep, they'll pick up their first of the game, so it will be all tied up dragon-wise. Oh, meanwhile, they found Fury in the jungle. What in the world was he doing there? Wow, easy kill for Iksu, and they're going to not stop there. Iksu very low, though. They probably should stop there. Kuvei comes in, helps set up a kill for Eve. Another one comes in for Kuvei as well. And looks like Anarchy needs to go on the run. That was a bit of an odd series of events. Fury somehow baiting Anarchy into a couple kills.
Well, Fury was alone, and so it was an easy pickup for them. But then they decided to commit to the fight after that, even though multiple members of Anarchy weren't there and four members of Samsung were. So they fought an uneven fight after that, and Samsung just said, well, fine, we'll commit to that. We have the victor pop down the Chaos Storm and win the engagement.
Yep. Meanwhile, this turret taking a bit of pressure, but Iksu was dead until a moment ago, so that's about all that Kuvei will have to worry about for the moment.
Yeah, not too much. So it's kind of a strange series of events right there.
This is a weird game, isn't it?
It's a very weird game.
Yeah. It's not exactly the...
Also, Kuvei going for a Randuin's Omen next, another weird facet to this when he's dealing with a lot of mixed damage, especially since he doesn't have any MR to this point besides his natural MR against a Fizz, Eve, Twisted Fate. Don't know about that. Kind of an odd decision.
It is strange. It'll still be fairly tanky either way. And you know, again, with the MR gain per level for Shen, maybe you can just do this now.
It's still good to have a little bit of MR, I think. At least a cowl in this situation to compensate. So,
well, we'll see what he decides to pick up next anyway.
Anarchy has to start thinking about this Baron. They're getting close to a Blade of the Ruined King onto Iksu, which means that they just go ahead and do this.
They're not even going to wait. Yeah, Anarchy just going for this Baron right now. Samsung knows what's up, though. Anarchy may need to turn off of this.
Yeah.
Yeah, they will.
They don't have the tankiness to actually commit to that kind of engage. Mickey's still here, and he's able to split push against Kuvei. Just doesn't have any MR, so this is basically just free damage.
Yep, pretty much. Oh, boy. Yeah, Kuvei cannot stop this at all.
That's why you build MR, Kuvei.
Oh, Shen. Mickey's like, haha, that was easy. And tier 2 in a lot of trouble. Crown's coming over, but he definitely is not going to make it in time.
You know what you get when you don't build MR?
What?
You don't get a tier 2 turret in bottom lane.
Oh, and Crown just going to teleport away.
Yeah, that was
Mickey just teleporting away.
That was just totally free for Mickey. Nice. Force the Baron. His allies are forcing the Baron. He gets the 1v1 with the top laner who has no MR. That couldn't have gone better, really. Anarchy now trying to start this one more time. Iksu, the defender on the back of the pit. Lyra's still too low. They can't do this.
No, they definitely can't. And Samsung, we'll see if they want to try to commit to something here. But nope, just content to keep Anarchy off of the Baron. Makes sense. Kuvei pushing down bot lane a bit.
Yeah, they are going to lose a bunch of pink wards for that last attempt. When you don't have somebody in the bottom lane to actually force Samsung to react, it's not so much of a good idea to start going for that Baron again, because you're just trying to make Samsung make a bad decision, right?
I mean, they're sending Mickey to push in this bottom lane, but he's really not the one that's ideal to do it right now, it seems like.
No, he definitely is. And here
Even
we go, TP.
Even without the global?
Oh, TP Fizz.
Yeah, trying to come in behind Kuvei. Can they catch him? Flash gold card onto Kuvei. Iksu's all over him as well, too. There's the ultimate pop by Fizz already. And Kuvei's not making it out of this one. Iksu with another kill.
Mr. Zero Magic Resist.
Doesn't do too well against TF Fizz, does it? Even if it is AD Fizz.
No, absolutely not. You're still going to be taking that percent damage from Fizz's, in terms of magic damage, from his natural abilities. So, oh boy, bit risky there for sure.
Anarchy still can't do the Baron, though. Doesn't look like it anyway. And Mickey just pushing up this lane. All he needs to do is shove this wave and then get close enough to teleport. We'll see. Looks like they're going in. Ooh, Lyra taking a lot of damage, though. Drops the ultimate. Here comes Mickey with the Gate of Destiny, but immediately body slam. Knocked in by Eve. Zonya's keeps him alive for the moment anyway, but Fury's starting to lay down the damage. Wraith with another big play, and here we go. Samsung coming in, and they've got the engage they want to do. Kuvei flashing for the taunt onto Songyun, but Songyun able to hop away. They're just going to turn right onto that Baron.
Yeah. So Lyra gets caught out. Mickey makes a very poor decision to try and save him, but actually just pops out and doesn't do anything at all. Hits his Zonya's with a tiny amount of HP. So Baron will go over to Samsung, and that may be all she wrote for Anarchy. I don't think this split push is going to be working anymore, especially as Kuvei goes back, starts to build that Aegis.
Well, this game is beginning to look a lot like last game, isn't it?
Well, that's the danger of playing split push in this meta, Doa.
Yep, that's right.
So coming in right Mickey. There, that was a great death ray right on where he was spawning, but Mickey is just CC'd. But it started out with Lyra just getting caught. And
Zonya ended right before the barrel.
Yes.
That's funny.
This did. And nice attempt at a taunt flash there, but it's just not enough to actually close that gap. All the main engage tools, the Alistar combo, and the explosive cast from Gragas were down, so that's the best you got is a flash taunt at that point.
Well, unfortunately for Anarchy, this is going to be another dragon for Samsung as well, too. There's not going to be a ton stopping them, it looks like. Well, maybe. Kuvei can still teleport down.
Yeah, taking this Shen, even though there are questions about the Shen's itemization in this particular game, he's got the cowl, so that will hopefully help solve his problems. Even though there were those questions, having the two globals against the split pushing is just incredibly helpful, as we've seen from Kuvei. And now that he has a bit more tankiness versus the magic damage, he's going to be doing a lot better off when it comes to holding the split.
There we go. Got that blue buff.
Treasure it forever.
Yep. Wraith. Oh boy, they might try to make a play here onto Ixude. Oh. Trying to be sneaky. Looks like it's just going to be a recall for Eve and a few other members of Samsung just to reposition themselves a bit.
Well, Samsung really isn't turning on the heat right now. They have to do something to actually push their advantage. Shen is still very scared to push it up. They don't have any deep wards or really, they only have a couple wards past the river at all, so they don't want to just be soloing this. However, they have to be decisive right now while they have the Baron buff. Maybe take a tier two, at least one. Sure, they're going to be in a good situation come the late game, but you can't just let this go completely by without actually putting any pressure. You're just going to lose your tier two and top like we're seeing right now.
Yeah. Yep, Ixu's just going to poke away at it. Kuvei's going to try to save it. Goes in for the top, but Mickey's just taking out bot. Oh, boy. Meanwhile, Samsung does push down the middle.
Stop being a pansy and just dive with your Shen. Just
wow.
Do it.
Monty just laying it out there, and they will just walk up. Looks like they're going to trade inhibitors, though, unless Kuvei can stop this. Can he do it? Taunt onto Mickey, Kuvei trying to do it, but nope. Actually, that inhibitor's still alive. No, never mind. Never mind. So inhibitors traded. Anarchy gets the bottom one. Gold card. Oh, boy, that was a nice gold card. Mickey trying to teleport away. Makes it.
I think you just have to go all in right there. Samsung's response is going to be,
hide.
Hide.
Very afraid.
Well, that inhibitor on bottom side is way more valuable than the one in mid two, because if you're trying to contest this Baron when it comes back up in your Anarchy, pushing out the mid wave is what you're going to be doing anyway. So clearing out some super minions isn't going to bother you that much. Meanwhile, being all the way on the other side of the map, much more problematic.
Oh, totally.
So Anarchy could get the drop as a result of which inhibitor is down for which team.
Well, the split pushers have become together pushers for Anarchy.
Together on a ward pushers.
That's right. hiding the brush pushers.
Oh, and now they think they haven't been seen because that ward just expired.
They're so sneaky.
They think they are. Little do they know that Samsung knows exactly what's... Oh. Surprise was ruined.
How did they see us? Right now they're blaming each other for stepping out of the bush at the wrong time. That's what Samsung wants. Descend to the ranks.
Tilt them from within.
That's right. Just tilt them.
Come on, man. TSM style. That's their patented strategy.
Just split push them.
Just tilt them. Anarchy is just split push them forever.
Yeah. Skirmish them.
It came with three different 1-3-1 comps tonight.
Well, Samsung trying to chase Lyra down. Nope, they're not. I just said that because it sounded exciting. I guess.
Live for excitement, the dull way.
It wasn't originally one. By the end of the sentence, I was like, oh, it's not really happening,
Goodbye,
is it?
Bye, Vicky.
See ya. Oh, didn't go very far.
Tip of the hat to you. Takes your tier two and then salutes you. What a jerk.
What a jerk. Showing signs of politeness.
It's the sign of politeness while he's killing your base that's offensive, Doa.
It's the manner. The manner politeness. But when I say manner, I mean bad manner.
The bad manner politeness.
That's right. It's polite in a very impolite way.
You have to take everything in its context, right?
Of course. The Wraith hasn't been able to quite find the plays that helped Samsung do so well last game either, so this game is still very close. Samsung, I feel like, could win a team fight. Really, either one of these teams could win a team fight. But Samsung has much less of a chance if they stand in the ward.
Yeah, they've got to do something here. Mickey's playing it smart. There's not a lot of wiggle room for Samsung. Samsung just has to be decisive about where they're going right now because they're going to get picked apart. And they have to be okay with really never having control of these minion waves.
I feel like the award for the least used Barons in this tournament have gone to Samsung in this series so far. Get the Baron, do nothing with it.
It's pretty disappointing. So, I mean, sure, they have to respond to this.
All right,
here
Mickey.
Comes the Baron. Anarchy has, they are totally controlling this game right now.
Yes, they are.
And Dragon and Baron are going to be up very soon, and there just aren't any wards for Samsung either, so Anarchy has been tightening the noose very slowly with their split push.
One good team fight, though, is all it would take for Samsung to come back, though.
Well, if they can ever catch them. I mean, Anarchy's being incredibly annoying by putting pressure on without even being in a position to fight.
Yeah. Samsung has had enough, though. They are going to just bull rush down the mid lane. They want to make something happen here.
Well, they have to, otherwise they're going to lose absolutely everything. But they still don't have the wards. Here we go. There's the gate just into the mid lane, actually.
Dragon and Baron coming back at the same time, too. And they see the gate not used, so they're just going to go for Baron. Samsung, they're seen, though. I mean, the gate was still up when they started this. Lyra going to wait to come over the wall. TP coming in as well, too. They back off from the Baron for the moment anyway. Grab onto Crown, but it gets cleansed. Ixu looking at coming in. This is very dangerous for Samsung, trying to zone with that Victor. Snowflower coming in the back line, so Exhaust goes down onto Mickey, and he's going to back away. Fury with the first kill here. Can Samsung win this fight? Lyra a bit disjointed. No real room for Ixu to come in on the outside, and Mickey's on the run. Samsung getting that fight they wanted so badly. Two kills for Fury. Eve picks one up as well, and Samsung able to get that team fight. Songyu not even there to really participate.
Well, that's how you do it, Doa.
Yes.
You have these people who refuse to fight you. Well, you force the fight. Shen was in the base. Shen had a way to get in. And you say, we're going to take Baron, and we're going to just run down mid lane with our super minions unless you do something about it right now.
Are no minions. Are they just going to try to end it here? Taunt onto Songyu, and he's the only one left. There's a knockup, another kill for Kuve, and it looks like Samsung just wants to end the game right here. That's a lot of turret damage. Snowflower's up. How annoying can this guy be? Probably not enough to stop Samsung from taking this turret. We'll see. That turret doing a lot of damage, getting down to low health. Looks like Samsung, though, should be able to close it out, and they will. So one bad team fight, like we said, that's all Samsung needed to take the game and take the match. GG.
Yeah, very nice Very nice play at the Baron at the end. They finally actually, you just can't be a pansy, because the more of a pansy you are in that situation, the easier it is for the split pushing team to just slowly pick you apart. You have to be so decisive at that objective. So they push up the mid lane with their supers. They say, screw it, Fizz, screw it, TF. We've got one Shen in our base. He's at least going to save the base, if nothing else. And we know that if we get Baron and we just walk up mid lane, you cannot resist our pushing power. We will win in a base trade scenario. So
worked well.
Yep, good call from Samsung. Split push still has problems closing in the current meta. And that's that.
Yep, pretty much a win for Samsung.